Fill her up.
You're listening to the Gas Digital Network.
What's up, everybody? It's Robert Kelly, and we're back. We got Joe List, a.k.a. The Truth, Dan Soder, a.k.a. Corporate Dan.
Not anymore. I don't have any corporate ties. So
Louis J. Gomez.
Suck my dick.
Your corporate is not your...
No, it was. It's not always, since the beginning, has been I've had a corporate job.
Do you think that's what it was? Louis J. Gomez, a.k.a. Yes. The Puerto Rican rattlesnake. I'm Robert Kelly.
Do you think that's what it was about? Or is
AKA
your
dude.
It was Guinness.
Can
corporate
I
attitude.
The fucking show?
No, Bob, I got this. Or is it your corporate attitude?
Because I had a corporate job.
Bobby, please.
You didn't have a corporate job.
Bob, Joe, give us a second. Hold on.
Put it on ice list.
Let's do it, Joe. You wanted to have a conversation? We'll have our conversation. How are you, Joe?
But you didn't have a corporate job back in
2011. No, you didn't.
Guinness.
No,
that's why I started calling me Guinness.
Oh, Guinness.
Guinness.
Oh, yeah.
Ever since then, I was tied to a corporation. Now I'm not.
Yeah, but you're corporate at heart.
Not anymore, dude.
There you are. Say something fucking crazy.
You're a fag.
Whoa!
What?
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 Edit.
What? No.
Edit.
This is live.
What do you guys want to do? You want to blow this bus up?
Yeah.
Oh, boy. Here
we go.
Dan's back, folks.
I'll blow this whole fucking thing up.
It's young Dan again. He doesn't care about shit.
The power.
Do you remember the Regz 10 years ago where none of us thought we were ever going to have careers?
Yeah, I thought I was going to go back to waiting tables.
N-word, fag. Let's go. Let's party, baby boy.
Yeah. I had four mush editing all that up.
Now Joe's like, hold on. I'm on to some stuff.
Hey, it's Joe, it's not going to happen.
You call me Jay.
Damn, dude, he called you his other lovers.
That's the first letter of your name.
Oh, my God. I can hear the Reddit threads blowing up.
Thank you, doggy.
Yeah. What up, L?
What up, Jay?
What's up, L?
Yo, D.
Ho, ho, ho.
I don't like that.
Can I say something, Dan?
The R is for retail.
Can't say it.
Hey, Dan, he's not corporate either.
We're talking fine. That's a medical term.
By the way, you're the only corporate entity in the room.
You really are, dude.
I am.
Yeah, you have a contract.
I don't say those
with
words.
The Darth, with the Sith Lords of Sirius XM.
I may be retarded, but your mouth looks retarded.
Come on, man.
What?
Why are you guys coming at me, dog?
That was the first shot at you.
No, he said something earlier.
I didn't
about what?
Yeah, you said I have a small dick and bad teeth and herpes.
That was in your head. I never said that.
That's just
you. You keep getting browner.
That's your internal monologue at all times?
Yeah.
Small dicks, bad teeth.
It's weird you're getting browner, but you're on time.
Doggy.
That's good.
I was on time.
That was good.
I was early. I was here 4 minutes early downstairs arguing with Beatrice.
That's not downstairs.
Is
not
this 2012?
Old Regz anymore.
I love this shit. Give me a Budweiser. I'm fucking back.
Oh, this is terrible.
We got a sponsor, too.
Yeah.
That's great.
We got our first ever sponsor. That's what it
says. One show in, we got a sponsor.
Sheathunderwear.com. It's the summer, and you don't want to be without
you. You don't just go into the...
Yeah, you do. You get it out of the way. No, do your homework so you can have fun on the weekends.
That's not the way it works.
That's not the way it works.
It's a mid-roll.
If your parents weren't killed, you'd know this.
It's a mid-roll.
You got to...
Calm down.
You can't go from corporate to rogue like this.
A dog. I've been rogue.
No, the problem is his corporate side is coming in. He saw a read, and immediately he was like, I must read corporate Dan.
I went like this, Lewis.
We got a great deal this summer.
I was like, it's still in me. Isto no andotos onomos.
You guys are doing a great job. Don't forget to go to the regs.com.
Dan's whipped up today. I love it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Dan, you look good. You shaved your beard. You got a haircut. You lost a little weight.
Yeah.
You look
Stop drinking soda.
Is that it?
Nice.
What type of soda were you drinking?
Ginger ale, like an old
Dan.
Fart.
Ginger ale.
That's like an old fart. Right?
Like you had a tummy ache?
Yeah.
Joe, I liked it.
Dan Soda? Yeah,
it was good. I liked it.
It was good.
I liked it.
I quit soda, too.
Massachusetts mushmouths. You guys can't say my last name properly.
We say soda.
Yeah, it's soda. How do you say my last name, Lewis? All right.
Damn
well,
it.
He's still here.
Can we bleep that, please?
Seriously, Louis.
I mean, come on.
Jesus.
What? It ends in an ER. So, soda.
Oh,
you my soda.
Natalie.
That's bleeped, right?
Bleep that.
Jesus.
We bleeped the last one. They're bleeping. They're bleeping.
They're
this
bleeping
isn't fucking Legion of Skanks. We bleep here.
We bleeping. Right. We're blopping. But I'm not the corporate one.
That's true.
You won't say that.
No, I won't. No, I won't.
Not on air.
Anymore.
Only when the Niners lose.
He calls them the 49ers.
I mean, my God.
That one was good, we're already though. Bleeping.
That was
a good
that
joke.
Was good. I mean, it was inappropriate, but it was.
Dude, the first five minutes of this episode. Boop, 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 boop.
What? To stay on YouTube, you gotta edit now.
I know.
This tea is horrible. Can they go back to Barks and get me a new
this
one?
Is bad.
Dude, he hates his. You hate
fresh
yours?
Fresh round of Bucks.
I brought my own, so I got the order right.
Yeah, can you get mine and make it a medium?
Mine tastes like cat puke.
All right, get a new tea.
Damn, I hope you guys are putting your fucking private parts in all of these orders. I hope Natalie's putting a little bit of puss lip in yours. And a little, he's putting his balls in.
Bobby,
the
is this
tea.
Your first time meeting Natalie?
Is that Natalie? Yes.
No, I met her at, where the
Natalie fuck? Rules.
We met her at Moon Tower.
Natalie's possibly the best employee guest. Outside of Shannon, Natalie's the best employee that Gas Digital
has. She's fucking great.
What
we
about all the other people?
They're all just lucky. They're just looking for homes. they're about to be destroyed.
No, that's not true. They're great. There's only two legitimately homeless people that work for us, so stop.
I got three autistic kids working for me now.
Yeah.
I don't think you can say autistic anymore.
Yeah, I did. You just said N-word five times.
No,
dude, we bleeped it. I did not.
Well, bleep that.
Whoa.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Whoa.
But I think autistic's getting dicey now. I think retard is more acceptable now than autistic.
Really?
Okay.
That's what I heard.
Well, if you use it in a derogatory term.
Yeah, you're fucking autistic.
Yeah, like he just
bitch.
Did with them.
No, they're autistic.
Are they actually autistic?
Yes, Danny. Yes, two of them are.
Yeah, but Danny's super autistic.
Yeah, Joe looks autistic. And he
Danny can tell you what day of the week you were born on if you give him the year.
Yeah.
Do it.
Danny?
Yeah, it was going to be a bomb, but then everyone said, you know what? I'll take it.
Yeah,
dude, I know.
It's okay.
Humility is knowing when God is right.
That's
sometimes
not,
we
that's
have
not
to
that's what
get
I
down.
Learned
sometimes we're going to not be funny on this show, and that's okay. If we're just funny the whole time, that's also unsustainable.
It's going to be too much. You think protecting our parts is funny all the time? No.
No.
It's almost never funny.
People I got a new theme song for the show because we used the other theme song, but I figured this show should have its own.
You made a theme song?
Yeah.
Behind my back?
Well, I'm gonna let you.
Why is it behind
now?
Your back and not all our backs?
Bobby's gay. Everyone else is straight. Bobby is gay. Everyone else is straight.
He used to be fat, but his personality's still fat. Wow, 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 wow.
Still craves cocks, even though he's skinny. Bobby's gay, but everyone else is straight.
They don't
Lewis, pussy. Joe, pussy. Dan, pussy. Bobby, penis.
I hope you get another corporate gig.
No way.
I hope you do.
No.
I hope it's so much money.
Oh, CBS is like a neighbor.
I read Carsey Warner comes back, gives you a Go Pilot, five seasons, and you have to go back to corporate Dan.
And I go, guys, let's have fun.
Delete that fag from the Regz episode two. Boys, I'm back.
That's like when you told me to delete the thing when you suck at my dick.
Yeah.
I still have that picture on my laptop, and it's so funny.
A lot of people.
Me and Jim Norton just gobsmacked at Lewis's form of sucking you clean.
It was actually shocking.
For those of you who don't know, Regz, you got to give a little background.
It's Regz history.
We did, you know what?
Context.
Yeah. Regz context.
Yes.
I'm familiar, dude. I created Bonfire context. So
don't
come
get mad
at
me.
Sideways.
I was just kind of going
come
with
at me
you.
Sideways.
I mean, dude, you're fucking. You need Allen.
Yeah, I know.
You need to go and fucking what about Bob Allen up in Vermont?
Katie said that last week. She goes, how much longer until Allen's
yeah,
back?
Yeah, dude.
I was like,
he's only been gone for a week.
Yeah,
has he?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm in big
What's
trouble.
Wrong with you?
I'm going to LA next week. I'm going to burn every bridge, dude. I'm in trouble.
Yeah, you got something behind your eyes.
Man. You know what it is? I
can't spell Allen without LA.
That's good. I stopped smoking weed.
What'd you take a class?
He's in night school.
Just puns.
L is sharp. L and D. What's happened? What was the story? You started telling a story.
You know what, dude? Context. It's you know what, dude? Context, because the Regz wasn't a show. Alive, you know what, dude?
Yeah.
Someone got Bobby a wooden penis?
That was me.
You're an idiot.
No.
You're an idiot.
No.
First of all,
what's up with the name calling?
Yeah. I'm sorry.
Yeah, why are you calling
what's
everybody
the name calling?
You
sorry.
Call
idiot's worse
names.
Than autist.
So you call everybody names lately. You've been fucking calling people idiot, cocksucker, stupid fuckface.
That's Lewis's just ethos.
Lately.
Yeah, I don't know, dude. It's called terms of endearment.
No. You got to explain that to people. You go, that means he likes you.
Yeah, duh. You didn't know that, dude.
We're going to be so sad when Lewis dies soon.
So what was I wrong?
You were saying it's was not.
I, no, but you.
So I'll tell
you
the story.
Sucked
I'll
dick.
Tell the story. I'll tell
the wooden dick was a bottle opener I got in Montreal.
No, it wasn't.
Yeah, I got a wooden gavel made by a wood guy. Maybe
you're all right. You're all just having separate conversations right now. And do you understand?
We're not alt right. We're just right leaning.
Our views are conservative.
We had a live YKWD with Bailey J, and we had a dick sucking competition.
Yeah, we're gonna have a dick sucking competition between me and transgender porn star Bailey J.
Yes,
it was Bobby's idea, and I'm a little fucking bitch, and I was like, I just want to be on Bobby's good side, and at his graces, because this is a decade ago, before I had passed Bobby in the business.
I mean, Jesus Christ, you've passed Bobby in the podcast business, not in the stand-up. You haven't passed
Chris Scopo in stand-up. By all measurable metrics, I've passed Bobby in every aspect of this business.
Yeah, tan, fighting, baldness. Yeah.
So
girlfriends you've dumped.
So,
All right, so you were there.
So Bobby's like, we're gonna do this dick type competition. So I'm like, all right, dude. I was like, I'm in, right? So then I went and I bought the dildo. I went to a fucking dildo store, and I fucked up because I didn't buy. Like, I could have bought, like, a big black dildo, which would have been funny. Yeah. I could have bought, like, a fucking, like, a rabbit that fucking spun and fucking.
You bought a dick that looked like my
dick. I bought a 5 1/4 inch fat guy dick.
Yeah, my dick.
It was sad. It was bent down. It had bumps on it. It looked like a.
It had a super finger on it.
Bobby got a super finger fucking tattoo.
We got it.
Don't do physical. Come on.
Guys.
What are you, crazy? That's how it gets unfun.
That's what we do. We're guys.
That's how
we're
it
guys.
Gets
I
unfun.
Give him a, I give him a fucking purple nurple. He gave me a little fucking...
Stop it. I saw your face. It's on tape. You were mad, and now you're going to pretend you're not
That's
mad.
That's what we do.
Because of some shit when you were a kid. You feel like you have to be tough.
Oh, stop.
That triggered you. That's... I saw it. It was on the camera.
Roll the tape. Guys, go to the clip.
Roll the tape.
Look at Bobby's face and freeze frame.
Dude, he becomes Alan as soon as Alan's out of town.
Okay.
Like, of course.
So you were triggered. That's all right.
You're mad.
Dan can't let me have an Alan impression.
Yeah, Dan's got to take it.
I'm going to tell you right now, because you've always shit on my Alan impression.
I didn't shit. I said mine was better. That's not shitting.
All right, go.
That's truth.
Let's hear.
Okay. All right,
let's hear yours.
Of course.
No, that's not a good.
You don't even know Alan.
I took two lessons from Alan.
Two lessons?
Yeah.
That's how fucked up. That's how fucked up Lewis is. Lewis goes in and goes, I'm not learning. Wow. He's like, I'm not learning my brain.
Paradiddle.
Okay. You're up there. Hello, how are you?
I do a great Alan impression.
Let's hear it.
You got to be weak and apologize.
That was pretty.
You know
good.
What?
That was better than I thought.
I think you got the best one.
I got the best.
No.
So I bought this dildo. Okay. I come in and I was like, all right. And then we were doing the competition. So I was going first in the competition. And I'm competitive. So I was like, I'm going to fucking win. I'm winning this competition unquestionably.
Right.
So then
you also have an insatiable thirst for cock.
Dude, I love cock so much.
Mm-hmm.
So we put this dildo in Bobby's pants and I fucking get down on my knees.
In front of the entire Village Underground.
The Village Underground. Norton's there. Fucking Bailey J's there. She's waiting to go second. 350 people fucking like losing their minds. I spit on the tip of the dick.
Get after it.
I spit and I told Bobby to put his leg up on a stool. I said, No, I'm not doing it again. It's fucking ruining my life.
Isn't this VU? My memory's all whacked out.
Did you
out.
See he had it? He was tempted to do it though.
I was.
He
went like,
it's instinctual.
Sorry.
He got lizard tongue.
So then I reach my hand in between his legs. I pulled them into my face. The crowd's losing their fuck. I literally standing ovation. People are fucking going nuts. And I just suck.
I'm getting real hard.
Supposed to be 30 seconds. I just fucking keep going. Keep sucking his dick, right? Everyone's going fucking
blew the light.
Shit, right? Blew the light. Blew Bobby. Blew the light. So then Bailey J, it was her turn to go. I was like, follow that, bitch. I remember I said that to her. I was like, follow that, bitch. And she comes up to the mic and she goes, yeah, I forfeit. He wins. So she didn't suck his dick. It was just me sucking his dick in the middle of the show.
Are you sure it wasn't the wooden bottle?
Not the wooden bottle.
No, it was 100%. He got a real...
Rubber dick.
He got a thing. The problem was, is that when we showed the video on YouTube, the dick was so realistic
dude,
looking.
No,
it looked like he was sucking my
You don't
dick.
Even know, dude. So now, like, you can just fucking edit. You can, on your phone, just go off screen grab. Cool. Edit. 20 seconds. So now it's just trolls like being like, anytime I mention my son, it'll be like, has your son seen this? And it's like, and
my son has.
Yeah. He won't even look Lewis in the eyes anymore. He's like, you blew my dad in front of people.
Yeah.
You gave great head, dude.
Thanks, man.
I mean, great head.
You threw yourself into it in a way that was respectable.
Well, I'm competitive. I want to win.
You did win.
Yeah. You did.
Yeah, the best part was when he reached behind in my ass.
I remember he pulled you forward.
But from my cheek.
I pulled him into my face.
Yeah. Was that a Christmas show? I'm
Do you remember?
Lost. I can't even. I remember, but don't remember. Was it at the big room, the VU?
Yeah. Remember in Coneheads when she ate the Subway sandwich?
Dude.
Yeah, VU.
Lewis has got that throat.
Dude, not even a. Didn't even hear that.
Where's Bailey J?
And then ringed it down to get all the.
What, Bailey J's just a dude now? She's like, oh, yeah, I went back.
She's like, yeah, I'm Bart.
Is she around? She used to always be around.
She's
Bart J.
What's up? I'm Bart Jackson.
She's down in Tampa right now. She looks better than ever. She's got big tits.
There's no way she looks better than ever.
Bring her up.
I guess dudes.
You look better than ever.
Dudes age really well.
Yeah, she's going to get handsome.
She's got salt and pepper.
She's going to be a silver fox, dude.
She has a receding hair.
Silver fox with a pair of jugs.
No, she looks great. Bring her up. Bailey J.
Yeah, dudes do get hotter. It's kind of crazy. Like 10 years ago, like this was like a big deal. Like, look at this hot tranny. Now, hot trannies are all over the place now, and we've all accepted that we would get our dick sucked by a tranny.
I love how she
progress.
I love how she just
not every photo. Bring up the most recent from her website.
No, that right there is how she looks now, and that is not great.
Do you remember? She like nuked Joe DeRosa's brain. Joe was like, I think I'm in love with her.
Yeah, all of us.
Yeah, she looks.
Oh, that's Bailey as a dude.
No.
Right there, Bailey J. Stock photo.
That's not, no, that's a fucking lie, dude. That's not her.
Am I dead naming her?
That's you.
What is happening right now?
No, who's the one below? The guy that looks on the left. That guy. Is that her?
No, that's a joke.
That's Andy Samberg.
Yeah, that's a joke, dude. All right. Not her. What are you fucking, crazy?
Who knows?
My fucking, are you fucking losing your brain? Can you bring up the photo of her now so they can see her?
Okay.
Jesus Christ, I got to go through his fucking finding it photo shit. Do you have the new song for the show? All right, tell me what you guys think.
Let's hear it.
Tell me when you're ready. One, two, three,
Regz,
go.
Regz. It's the Regz with Bobby
and Dan and
Lewis and Joe.
Lewis can say the N word. He's Puerto Rican. It's the Regz.
What do you think?
I don't know.
No, I think I think we can get a better edit.
Yeah.
I loved it.
I don't like that I'm last.
Loved it, Dan?
I think loved it.
Loved it?
Loved the lack of harmony.
Right.
Loved how it kind of just kind of scares you a little bit.
Shows you.
That's good.
You what the podcast is, what you can expect.
Yeah, zero production value.
People talking over each other.
It's perfect for the show.
I think it should be like, down, out, bow, 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 Bobby's a homo, yeah.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good.
He loves cock in his mouth and his ass. His name is Bobby Kelly.
You know what? I'll give guitars and you do the lyrics. And then, Dan, if you want to do drums or something like that.
Okay.
No.
You just sit there being a homo.
Well, we should have had somebody that can improvise go because Lewis is.
No, I'll do the drums because I can't improvise. No, you're doing
the lyrics.
Yeah, I'm doing bass and lyrics.
Oh, well, Bobby, you do the lyrics, but it's got to be about you being gay. Don't fuck this up.
Bobby, you have to be gay.
Bass, guitar, drums, ready?
Lewis, play us in.
Bobby, fucking a dick, taking it in the bum every day. Bobby. Swallows a cum, throws it on his face, he doesn't care anyway. Bobby, he's a big fan, loves it in his rear, takes it in his mouth. Bobby, he's a big gay, loves it fucking dick in his ass.
Bass solo.
What are we, South American?
One, two, three, four. Bobby sucks a fat chick, licks the balls and the asshole. Bobby licks good. Butts.
She's not aging well.
We just got everyone to turn off the
podcast. She's not aging well. She's a fucking, you know.
Why are you going to get, first of all,
it's a young woman's game.
Settle down and stop yelling at me.
Yeah. Her nipples are very nice.
You're too used to yelling at employees.
I can't see the cock.
Natalie, do I yell at you?
Yes.
Have I ever yelled at you?
I think I'm the only one at Gas Digital that you haven't
it's
yelled
coming.
At.
Natalie's doing an incidental Alan impression.
Yeah, she does
very
have
similar,
a goofy
like,
she's got a goofy voice. She's like, oh, I'm Natalie.
Okay.
No, he's never yelled at me. Yeah.
Turn down the volume.
I think I'm the only one. I've seen him yell at Bobby. But
okay.
All right, so you're gay.
Well, this coffee sucks.
Well, he's getting more.
He's getting new coffees. Relax.
What happened?
How come you can't see your dick?
How'd he fail all of them?
Please stop. You're gay.
Okay, I'm asking.
To say something.
She's still your friend. You got to be a fucking. Yes. What are you being an asshole, dude? You don't even talk to Bailey J. She doesn't like you.
I love Bailey J.
When's the last time you spoke to Bailey?
Last week.
Last week you spoke to Bailey J.
Yes.
Show me your phone. Show me the call log.
It's a trick, Bobby. He's gonna write something on your phone.
I don't care.
I'm gonna call 911 and then throw the phone.
You know what? You're not corporate anymore.
Let me see your last text message to Bailey J.
Yeah, but
let me see. Let's see what you're saying. Let me see your text messages, Bob.
Yeah.
All together. Let me read your text messages aloud.
Dude, welcome to Regz Court. You're the first fucking case.
Let me see your phone.
You're the please.
Let me see your text.
Please.
Messages. Really?
Dig in.
You got nothing?
Nothing.
I open it up.
I've never not had nothing.
Lewis is in love. Lewis is in love.
That's exciting.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for backing me up on that.
Well, I don't know. I didn't feel it.
You know what's funny is when you're around your girlfriend, I haven't seen that energy yet, but at the
that?
Stand.
Who's what?
Who's that?
Don't look at the pictures from my girlfriend, you motherfucker.
You just said go through the phone.
No, he's just looking at the pictures from my girlfriend because he's looking for nudes, you fucking asshole.
I was not. Why would
Why would he want to see that?
He clicked
lady
Jenna,
naked?
Then he clicked photos, and then he started scrolling through the photos.
First of all, I don't know your girlfriend's name.
Yeah, not a.
Second of all.
I don't know.
I was just scrolling through whatever.
You don't have to. You don't have to laugh that hard to kiss his ass.
He gets paid
to laugh. It's fucking sickening, dude.
He gets paid extra to laugh.
I know, dude.
Nothing's better than Lewis turning on someone that he can turn on.
Dude, he's like, fuck you, dude. What the fuck? You fucking laugh? You fucking piece of shit. He's laughing extra hard at Bobby's jokes, but not at ours. I see what's happening here, dude.
I got him to pop earlier.
Did you?
Yeah, he got him to pop. It's you. Don't get mad that he didn't laugh at you.
Yeah.
Max, I'll give you an extra 10 if you laugh.
Your energy around your smoking hot girlfriend is guy with a hot girlfriend.
What do you mean?
At Shane's show at the stand, I've never seen you around her. You do a lot of this look when you were with her. You go, yeah, I'm getting out of here. And I was like, you don't walk around like that. You're like leading her by the small of her back.
That's his new look, though. He walked into a bonfire the other day, and he's... Like, I was like, "What? Why is he so fucking cool?"
Because he was happy to tell Jay that we started this podcast. Because Lewis has been waiting to tell Big Jay that we started
I can disappoint Jay. Yes.
He just walked in and he's like.
Is Jay upset?
What? No, he's
not. No.
We should have him on. I say guests.
We don't have guests.
No guests, dude. No direction. No rules. You don't know
digital.
The old intro?
Hmm?
There's no rules, no direction, no guess.
Yeah, no rules. You're saying rule, no guess. That's a rule.
Shit, he's right, dude. Fuck.
No, but that's not a rule.
No, you walked right, that one.
You walked right in your own trap, you fucking moron. You autistic fuck.
It's like walking into a door that's closed and a glass. Like, oh, no.
Donk. No rules, except no guests.
Yeah, you walk into a door that's closed every time you submit a tape.
No tape.
Where's the box?
Yikes.
I started in the 90s.
92?
You know, they still call it a tape. It's a general term.
He's like, the fucking Yodas aren't going to book you like that, huh?
Even if it was a tape, he didn't submit anything.
Yeah. Was that a joke? I can't tell.
I just wanted to save you.
God, it's good to be back.
I couldn't even tell if that was a joke.
Do you think I didn't submit for late night and just not get it over and over and over again?
No, I think that.
Yeah, that's exactly
God, remember when those mattered?
We know that.
Yeah. Remember how much pressure it was to get a late night set on tape and now you're like,
when
fine.
Did it stop mattering?
YouTube.
I think COVID really made... COVID made like late night, like it never came back. Like awesome. Nobody gave a shit. People were doing like COVID late night sets in front of no audience.
But it depends on what we mean by... matter because it was long before that it didn't matter.
I mean, I'd probably say mid-90s is when it stopped mattering.
I think the time we've been doing stand-up,
there's so many, there was only two of them for a long time.
Yeah, Leno or Letterman.
Now there's five or six.
Yeah.
But now it's back down to like
Fallon, Kimmel. I'll tell you what, you want to get a late night set on Gutfeld.
Oh yeah, he's big.
He's the biggest guy out there. He's number one. Well, he also
they asked me to do Gutfeld.
They haven't shut down.
Doing that?
He doesn't use union writers, so they don't have to shut down.
Oh.
He uses Joe Mackey's one of the writers.
Yeah, right? But he just doesn't pay them. They're not in union.
Right, but he pays them good.
Does he?
I would imagine, right? No?
I don't know.
I like, I actually like Gutfeld's show a lot. I think he's pretty
good. Like news that rhymes? Every time I've watched it, he's like, Biden is riding for something else. And I'm like, damn, this really is for retards. This is a new show for retarded people. Biden's smiling and riding and gliding. And then he just goes to a guy who goes like, liberals are stupid. It's great. It is entertaining. I watch it on the road.
I've never seen it. I remember the old show he had, though.
Red Eye was fun.
Yeah, I did that show a bunch.
Red Eye was fun as fuck.
I love Red Eye.
I was on Red Eye a lot.
Yeah. I was always bothered me they didn't pay, and then they'd get you a car.
Yeah.
And I think multiple people had the stunt of like, well, can I just get the money the car costs? It's
did
right
you ever
off
ask
the D-Train. No.
They didn't like it.
No, I never asked.
You hit them with that theory, and they go, we have a car service. And you go,
I was on the last Red Eye ever.
Do you remember how they would put your makeup on with the gun?
Soder, not interested in your story.
No, dude, I wasn't. I moved right
on. I like it.
I didn't even speed bump it.
Who was on the last one?
I don't remember, but it was a chick.
I mean, you're not even listening
it
now.
It was Tom Shalhoub.
Let the kid tell a fucking story.
Yeah, and then, no, there was some chick, and then I almost, it was like a hot Fox News chick.
Always.
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 Yeah, that was our
they always had a lady with gleamed up legs.
Did I almost convince her to make out with me
who?
On air?
No, you
did. I swear to God, it was on air. I was like, you know, you should just make out with me right after the last ever Red Eye.
That's
how great.
Good.
We end it. The lights go out. It's just me and you deeply kissing. And I just watched her like look up like she thought about it because she realized how funny it would actually be.
Yeah.
And she's like, nah, I can't do it. But it was very close.
Back in the day, I was on one of those panels with a Fox and I got her number and
Hell
we started
yeah.
texting and she ruined it because I was like, oh, do you want to go out sometime? And she goes, will you take me to one of those cafes where the comedians and artists hang out? And I never responded after that.
Yikes.
And now she's like super right wing. And it's very funny. She's one of those people that has those YouTube shows where she's like, Fauci needs to burn at the stake. And you're like, remember when you asked me to take you to a cafe where the artists hang out? You fucking dork.
Name names, Dan.
No.
Yeah.
Come on, dude.
Because Megan even though I'm not corporate, I respect people's privacy. Hi, I'm libertarian, Dan.
Megan Kelly?
No. I didn't get a big fish like
Kennedy?
That. I got one of the small ones.
Kennedy?
Oh, I would have loved to fuck Kennedy.
I wanted to fuck
Kurt Loder.
Yeah.
It was Kurt Loder.
Yeah, you wanted a Kurt Loder on your back.
Right? That was good.
That was a good one.
Thanks, guys.
I like it. Hey, that was good.
Yeah. We're having a good time, I think.
No direction.
No rules.
No rule. One rule.
One rule.
One rule. No direction.
Well, there could be more rules as the show goes on.
If you really look at it, there's probably other rules.
My favorite of doing the show was the immediate excitement followed with the
coffee.
How long is this going to last? It was immediately like, they did it. This isn't going to go long.
Well, a lot of people are like, dude, I bet it's 5 episodes at the most. It's only once a month. We can keep this going. We can get this a year.
Maybe.
We can get 12 in a row.
Let's
have our goal be 12 in a row.
12 episodes, limited run, 1 year. We'll see if we come back for season 2.
Love that, doggy.
God damn it. It's why you're a business owner.
But
damn.
As somebody with a kid, you guys don't really understand how hard it is to get together.
What?
What? We all have kids, except for Dan.
You don't even have a kid yet, Joe.
Yeah, because I know the world's ending, so
yeah,
I'm going to put a child
your
through that.
Chickens till they hatch.
Yeah. What does that mean? We had
that
three babies
die. Your baby might die.
Real nice.
Jesus
We've
Christ.
Had three die.
Jesus, Bobby.
Real nice.
Bobby goes, until it comes out the pussy, it ain't a kid, dude.
Dad, it's going to be stillborn, likely.
Dad.
Yeah.
Dude, you can get a little
coming out, Dad.
Get
dad.
A little American girl doll that doesn't move, dude.
Bobby wants my kid to die.
You
got to
put that
it.
In a hefty, dude.
Yeah, you can have a little tiny coffin for it.
Dad,
it's sad, dude.
I have a little face, but it doesn't move.
It's hurtful.
I didn't say that.
It's
I just
hurtful.
Said you should wait.
You're
going
to probably dress it up anyway, you sick
know.
Fuck.
They're probably going to chop it up.
You're pro-life, and you're rooting for my child to demise? Whatever.
I'm saying... That you should just wait until it's in your hand.
Don't count your chickens.
Jesus Christ. Dude. He's got a baby
it's
on the way.
Literally
less than 2 months.
The analogy is there might be dead chickens in those eggs.
And Bobby hits him with it.
Hey, you know,
Bobby might as well have hit him with a stat. Goes, you know, there's a lot of stillborns.
Wow. You're getting a call after this. I'll just say that. All right. And I'm going to tell Sarah. Don't think I'm not telling Sarah.
Oh, my God.
You married us, for God's sake.
You don't tell Sarah. You're going to get in her head. She's not going to be able to carry the baby to term.
Yeah, don't.
I can't. First of all, I didn't really marry you.
Bobby, this will be on Bobby's head until your son is born.
What?
That you said, don't count your chicken until
he's born.
Yeah.
Don't count your chickens until they're born.
That was second if something did happen.
Dude,
that would be terrible. We could all reference this episode.
Oh, my God. Oh. I'd be like this. Scrub it. I'd be like, scrub that from the internet.
Dude, sometimes doctors will deliver a baby. This has happened multiple times. And they, as they're taking the baby's head out, they will decapitate the baby and pull the baby's head off.
Look
the body.
That up. That is absolutely
it's 100% true.
Look it
they
up.
Pop the baby's head off like
off.
A doll.
It comes off because the cord is wrapped and they don't see it and it pops off.
And then they go,
he goes like this. He goes, hey, hey, what am I? What do I own? A pizza shop? Hey.
They're like, which half do you want?
Yeah, look at the bottom half is shooting shit out of it.
All right. Come on. Can we clean it up, please? I hope your kids, I hope the bus rolls.
What?
Yeah.
What is that, college saying?
I didn't say anything. It was him.
You know what I love about all this? Wish nothing upon me. I'm childless.
Oh, shit, dude. Yeah, I hope you get your girl pregnant.
I hope she gets pregnant with triplets.
Oh, no.
And sick,
then,
dude.
Yeah.
Then one of them eats the other one inside of the
bus like this. I go, pop, 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 pop. The one who does will be my favorite.
What is it?
Conehead
say?
Is different.
Conehead after baby
decapitation
birth.
Decapitation can happen.
During breech delivery.
Dr. Han Hao Chan, an obstetrician. Especially when the baby's head is too big. Could have happened to Dan. Wow, I dodged a bullet. Dude, in the 80s, science was raw back then. They might have just popped it on and gone, hey, you had a football. Oh, my God, this is your son's head.
There was definitely a noise when Dan's head came out of his mom's vagina.
Yeah, it was my dad sighing, knowing he was never going to fuck my mom again.
You're missing two keywords. Allegedly.
That was very funny.
And
I
Brazil.
Thought it was all right.
Hold on.
I mean, it was great. It was awesome.
Was that laugh for me or Dan?
Don't fucking push your microphone away.
Fucking push this goddamn mic.
Don't be a baby.
I mocked my parents' sex life and you gave me nothing.
Yeah. You guys missed a big laugh from me, from Max, for me.
We got it.
Max
got
to go.
Why? They just laughed at you.
It's
They're laughing
too much,
at you
dude.
Now.
But it's all that was real because I was hilarious in that moment. But whatever it is, he's fucking doing like a laugh track thing. That stinks.
He
dude.
Finds
the darker
us
you
funny.
Get, the more and more you look like the Rock's brother he never talks to. He's just like you call him. You're like Dwayne. Hey, he's like, sorry, bro.
Yeah, your name's the Cock.
Whoa.
I was going to do a name thing, so I'm glad you did it.
Yeah. What was yours?
I'm not going to say it.
I actually laughed and pulled the laugh back.
Did you?
I felt embarrassed.
Like a check swing?
I was like,
yeah. A baby girl's head allegedly ripped off during delivery in Brazil. Huh?
Yeah.
Allegedly.
Yeah, in Brazil.
That's true.
That was a Zika head.
Is Zika still a thing?
I don't know if it's still a thing, but it was down there. It was big.
He's making those little tiny heads, yeah. Right?
Yeah. Ezekiel Elliott.
He's a free agent.
Yeah, I wish you were a free agent. You'd sign with a different podcast.
We get real hot.
You know what, dude? I just got a
Can
weird.
You fucking shut the fuck up.
No. Let me get this.
No.
You just got a. Whoa.
What'd you get,
Lewis?
Wait, I want to know what you got. A weird what?
No. Forget it. Don't worry about
it. I wanted to hear.
Now have this show. Skim milk. Whatever. Bobby's drooling on himself.
That was wild.
What'd you just have?
Bob, we're equals. You don't get to just choose that I don't have a microphone because you're mad that I talked over you when we all talk over each other.
Right? You talk
It's
over
what we do, dude.
It's what we do.
It's what
That's
we
what
do.
We do.
You're right. We do rip.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, but why do you have a better microphone than all of us?
You can have mine. You want
Yeah, Shure's are fucking great. But, Lewis, tell your story. Speak, King.
What's up? What's going on? This is way louder.
Also, this is way lower.
I know. I've told them to...
I like that better.
Yeah, Lewis should be low. Lewis, go, dude. Sing
an hour
a song.
Ago.
You're allowed. The fuck is this story?
It's not even a story. I just got like deja vu.
Oh.
Just from like being here with us.
Deja douche.
Deja boo.
Fuck, look at the yams on lip.
No, I got deja vu from being here. It brought me back to whatever the feeling was of us being young fucking comics.
Well, Bobby was never young on this
and
show.
Just caring
fucking
about
young.
Fucking being here. Funny. There was, you remember when we did this, Bobby was hoarding all of the money.
All
Any dime.
I never got a dime.
You never made a dime off, you know what?
You never made a dime.
Buddy.
Well, I'm you're bad at business.
Hey, more like you know
right
what,
now,
Jew.
When I did this fucking podcast, I never made a fucking dime.
Why not?
Because I did it because I just like doing it.
I would have rather gotten ripped off by you than finding out you made no money.
First of all,
can I tell you that right now?
I'll tell you right now.
You know what, Jew?
We never had Patreon.
No direction. No money.
No profits. We're in the red, dude. We're in the red.
There was ad reads.
John's mad at me. I got to sell my house in Hell's Kitchen just to pay for the shirt mics, dude.
Thanks, guys. Fix it. Fucking microphone stinks.
It's sure it doesn't.
I know,
best,
but it's
best
it's,
in the
it
market.
It needs a thing, and they always put the fucking limiter on it. Yeah. I didn't make a dime off it. Actually, it cost me money. I had to pay for all the bullshit.
You,
when you two drank.
I drink.
Yeah, but we were crushing fucking half racks, dude. Yeah. We were drinking 12 packs.
I smoked some herb.
Yeah, dude. I never
remember when we smoked weed.
When you guys were on it, I never made a fucking dime.
Why not? You should have.
There was no podcast networks. There was no.
You had your own.
There was advertising. That wasn't a thing. All that shit.
We had ads.
We read ads.
We
read ads a lot.
That's why I figured we weren't doing free ad reads.
No,
but I guess we were. Oh, cool, Bobby. Way to renovate. Was, way to reinvent the game.
There was merch, what too. Ad reads and merch.
Merch, live shows. Merch. I sold posters that I never got a dime from.
Remember when you'd make you when you'd open
he'd
for
make
Bobby?
Me fucking go sell his merch like he'd a like, faggot.
He'd be like this. He'd go out there, dude. Go out there. You fucking go sell posters.
Thank you.
Done.
You know what? I don't need it because I got $100 from Lewis last time.
I'll take Joe's 20 though.
Yeah. Dude, Bobby, you should have made so much money off our young backs.
I didn't do it.
You should have been the slave master.
I didn't do it.
Wait, we did have ad reads though.
We did.
And we sold posters. And I remember Bobby would like yell at me for not selling posters good enough. Like it wasn't like
dude, I remember
no,
one
this
time.
Is, this is Lewis. Lewis, listen, will you fuck Ollie's?
What?
Fuck Ollie's.
Whoa.
You're acting like you've never been on the road.
Wow. We were kidding about the Bobby is Gay song.
Yeah.
We were just joking, dude.
I would bring this fuck with me.
Yeah.
And he was a fuck. He was a burden. A
yes.
fucking pain in the ass.
That's the friendship of Lewis. You know that when you sign up.
Yeah, cheese burden.
Burton Kreischer.
All right. I didn't know we were going puns. I didn't know we were going pun heads.
Can I just say, by the way, real quick, Bert and I have no beef. We're friends.
What are you talking about?
Crazy.
Nobody said it. We just mentioned Bert. You're freaking out right now.
Look at him. He's got red.
You talked about it last time.
He got red. He got red in his face.
And then somebody took a video of you talking about it and literally made a video with arrows pointing that say these two hate each other. And it has like 700,000 views.
Did you see the...
It's huge.
There's another one that says Louis J. Gomez calls Bert Kreischer on his shit. And it's just me telling the story about how Bert mistakenly said he called me... I met him and called him Puerto Rican rattlesnake, and they were like, "Look, everyone knows that Bert's a lying piece
yes.
of shit."
Yeah, everyone's fucking me. We've hugged it out. We're talking. I blew
you guys
him.
Are cool.
It's great.
But
very
what,
cool.
So, but now you can talk about what happened, though.
Yeah, but you yeah. did. You were
heated.
You were.
I was
very
mad that day in fucking February of 2021, and then we hugged. And
here's what bothered me about the story is that Bert was like, "I bought everybody $200 worth of Thai food." It's like, dude, $200 worth of Thai food anybody can buy. What? That's not going to brag.
Yeah, and that's not enough for Bobby to even...
Look, Joe's getting mad.
to appetize him.
I don't need...
But anyways, wait, what story were you telling?
I don't shine shoes no more. You've been gone too long. I got a tiny stomach.
Lewis, I don't eat like that. Lewis.
No more fat jokes.
I have a baby stomach.
no more fat jokes, Tommy. You've been away a long time. They didn't come down and tell you.
I don't eat food no more. I
don't
eat food no more. Just drink shakes.
Did we really have reeds back then?
Yes.
Lots of them.
100%.
100% yeah. We had reeds. That's why I don't believe any of this, that you made no money.
Comedians,
Joe Lister, Bert Kreischer beef over pizza.
Comedians are turning on Bert Kreischer.
Yeah, that one. Look at that. Look at the views on that one. It has like a million views. We didn't turn.
There's no turn.
We never liked him.
How does he have a million views and our episode didn't?
Look at that. They're using
345,000 views.
2 days ago. Using our shit.
This is comedy enforcement. Dude, they have 82,000 subscribers. It's a big comedy channel. We made it.
Looks like we made it.
2,064 comments. Can we read some of the comments?
Look how we've got. Oh, I don't want to see the comments.
With Bart's insane inner monologue and propensity to lie, I can't wait to see how he handles people openly hating him like Brandon.
We shouldn't be promoting this. We should be promoting Matt McCusker's special on the
Matt McCusker. His special. He's on one of the regs. I got a new special coming out.
Well, you do?
Yeah.
I have one
half
out
hour.
Right now.
Gas
December 5th.
Mine's out right now.
It's
August
18th.
Oh, it is.
So it's out.
But this comes out in fucking November 2025.
YouTube. This is coming out like the day that my special is coming out.
Go watch Lewis and Joe List.
Brand new specials.
I think you know which order to watch them in.
Yeah.
Lewis has a special. Gas Digital. They have how many specials
Gas
coming out?
Six specials coming out.
Six specials coming out.
Are they all released on September 5th?
No. They're all released individually. Mine's the third one.
You got Lewis J. Gomez, Dave Smith, Kurt Metzger.
I was in the middle of it.
Yeah, I was nailing it.
You don't got to really plug the other specials. Mine's fine. Don't watch any of the other ones. Watch mine six times.
No. Watch.
No Voss.
Whose comes out today? Just yours?
Just mine, yeah.
Just yours. September 5th, Lewis J. Gomez. Go to Gas Digital Network. Or go to
it's
the
on
YouTube.
My YouTube. It's on my YouTube channel.
It's on Lewis J. Gomez.
Just click over right now. It's on YouTube.
Do they get to put the specials on their own YouTube?
Yeah. Everyone owns their own shit.
That's sick.
Great. That's fucking great.
Everyone owns their own
Dan,
shit.
Dan, you got some good ones, too. You got yours. You got Jordan Jensen.
Jordan Jensen's is great.
You got Kurt Metzger.
Kurt's genius.
Kurt's fucking
Kurt's one of the greatest comedians.
And there's not one bad special on it.
Yeah,
usually when people
you know
put
what, there's one bad one, you guys can decide which one it is.
You know what, though? When you look at that lineup, you guys are booking better lineups than, like, anybody else that's doing specials.
Yeah, but they did it quick, which I love.
At the
cutting room. You mentioned it, and then I think in the next couple of months it was done.
Yeah.
And then check out Joe List's already out. It's been out for a week. We've plugged it.
What happened?
I'm joking.
Listen, what happened? yesterday. I don't know if you guys saw this. My friend Mike Calta, who you
he's dead
with. You guys, you friends again, right?
Are you guys cool or angry?
You guys are cool.
I'm cool enough. With
I think
him.
He's cool. Yeah, he's cool with you.
Well, I saw. I didn't know what the fuck it was. And then someone on Twitter.
He was set up.
Shit, is he actually
somebody
dead?
From another radio show? The Bubba, whatever. Bubba's Bubba girlfriend sponge. Went down with a list of
which
shit.
Which wrestler is she banging?
Walking up to the phone. No, it's that's the wife.
I know. That's what was a joke.
Yeah, sorry.
So the new girlfriend was fucking another wrestler.
She walked up with at a live event with
saw that.
Phone.
Like in a booth.
Stuck it in his face. A fucking agenda. And he tried to talk to her.
What was the point of what she was doing, though?
She was trying to get him to get mad.
She was
get
trying to cornered. Trigger him.
If you watch the video, she's like going like this in his face.
Yeah. Yeah.
He does a very, what I would say is an LJG move, a Luis J. Gomez move. Yeah. He just takes the phone and fucking stops recording.
Well, he takes it and turns it back and basically goes, yeah, I'm a loser because she's calling him names. All these people are here to see me. Who the fuck are you? Blah, blah, blah. And then he goes, you want your phone? Leave. They'll give it to you outside. And then she went to grab it. And she jumped on him, and he pushed her the fuck off and said, get the fuck off me, word, cunt, whatever he said.
Whoa.
And then they took her out, and she immediately started going, battery, battery, he batteried me.
Battery.
Yes.
No, maybe she was like, my battery, it's at 2%.
Battery.
Can somebody please give me a charger?
You drained my, by the way, can I just tell you right now, corporate Dan being this?
Yeah.
That's some good corporate moves you just had right there.
You liked it?
I saw you defending your friend in a very corporate way. You skated backwards.
Allegedly. And I used the word allegedly.
And you pushed it away.
Well, here's the thing.
Did he call you after it?
Well, they...
On her phone?
He was recording. The video you see is from his phone.
Yeah.
But he had to give that allegedly to their lawyer.
You got to keep on saying allegedly. That wasn't even the right context.
I like using the word.
He had never heard it before the Brazil headless baby story.
Yeah.
He goes, allegedly. Now I can put that in any sentence. Now I can use that with anything.
It's like my allegedly. Mic's not working.
He goes, allegedly, this coffee sucks.
It's working now. That was his, but they took the whole video where he brought her up. She was like shaking and they were kicking her out. And he's like, what's wrong? Why? What's going on? She was like, I just wanted to ask some questions. And he's like, come over. And he said, let her come. This is all not in the video because they edited it out.
Yeah.
And he was like, sit down. You don't have to shake. You can ask me the questions. Go ahead. And she starts asking questions about the case and about Bubba. And he answered it, the first one. He's like, well, the reason why that and you have this email is because of this and that. And it was this. And she was like, oh, I didn't know that. And then she goes right into another fuck you, gotcha thing on video.
And so she's from the Bubba Love Sponge show, and she's trying
girlfriend.
To
it's his girlfriend.
His girlfriend's trying to catch him,
yeah.
You know, saying shit so they can go viral.
You gotta have some decent dick for a woman to be like, yeah, I'll go sabotage a guy. I'll go.
I don't get it. What were they trying to get him to do?
They were trying to get him on video to get just to have content of fuck him, you know. And so what they got that video and they edited it. They put titles. Emphasize what he said. Slow mode, fucking anger.
Fucking cunt.
Cunt.
Allegedly.
Allegedly a cunt.
Alleged cunt. Did, what is the, I thought Bubba and him were done with the beef. Is this still?
Well, no, it's not done. Mike's number one in Tampa area on the number one morning show, and Bubba's doing an internet radio show from a shed.
Ooh. Like us.
Nothing wrong with that, because I do it.
Yeah. The Shed was a fun series.
It was a fun series. Yeah. I'm going to bring it back.
But can I play devil's advocate?
Yeah.
I mean, you can't take somebody's phone from them. You literally can't. You can't, like, from a logical standpoint, I'm going, I can't take a woman's phone out of her hand, and now it's, whether she's sitting with me or not.
Conor McGregor.
I'm not saying that I would. I did that shit fucking, me and Kim Congdon, we were getting off a flight. And this bitch started arguing with Kim. So then I just got in between them. I was like, yeah, you're not going to fucking. She starts arguing with me. She pulls out her cell phone, right? And I was like, all right, bitch. And then I fucking spit on her, I think. And then Kim grabbed her phone and just threw it across the airport.
Oh, you guys were a power couple.
I was like, go find it, you fucking dumb cunt.
My God, dude.
Beat it. I'm on a bug anything.
So you're on Mike's.
I would do the same. I'm just saying, I know now you can't do that.
Can I ask you how, like, were you in the terminal and you took the phone and fucking whipped it?
No, we were getting off the flight, and it was like one of these flights where, like, I guess we didn't have any luggage space above us, so Kim had to, like, go, like,
you have to
wait seats back.
Oh, okay.
Because you were late.
Maybe. So she had to, like, put her luggage, like, four seats back. So she was just trying to, like, just, like, get it. She was like, oh, can I just, like, grab that? And some black chick was like, no, you go wait. And then, like, you know, black and Puerto Rican are like, fuck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ebony and ivory.
Top two races, if you ask me. One and two.
Yeah, and then they started arguing.
You pick which was one and which was two.
Yeah, then they started arguing, and then I just, you know, I started arguing with the chick. And she spit on me, and then I spit in her face, like, hard. And then she had her cell phone. I started, like, videotaping, and Kim just goes, it was, like, silent. You heard just go, good. In the distance.
Like one of her
she have to go, did she have to go run and get it?
Yeah, she had to go pick up her
phone. That would have been a funny video.
Just no, but then security, because you're not allowed to do this.
Because blacks and Puerto Ricans are fighting. The whites are nervous. They go, I'm a Delta Platinum.
So,
I don't need this.
So
and
here
me?
We,
was that an impression of me?
So here we are at me. The Spirit Airlines counter, obviously.
I'm Platinum.
I'm Diamond.
I'm Diamond.
I'm Platinum.
I'm in 3 years running. Your story sucks. Diamond, 3 years in a row.
Me too.
Years in a row?
Four.
That's a lie.
Check the stats.
I don't believe it. Sorry, what were you saying? Some bullshit.
She threw the phone, but where did she throw it? Like
she threw it down the hallway.
That's great.
Like just in the terminal, and then security was like chasing us. Like me and Kim, literally, we split up. I was like, I'll see you at home, and we went and we got our own taxis. We took our.
She went, mi amor. This is exactly what I'm doing. I have to run from you.
No, I went to the bathroom. I changed my clothes.
Pissed a Z on the floor. Yeah,
goes, just remember, this was done by a real ass dude. This lady goes back to the DMV. She goes, honey, I don't even want to tell you about my flight home. This Puerto Rican couple spit in my face. Don't. How did you? Now, my favorite Lewis spit story, the all-timer.
Which one?
It's pregnant B. You're getting on
I
stage.
Did not spit on her. I was talking.
No.
I was talking loudly
fucking
and
idiot.
Close to her face.
You just self-incriminated. You were waiting for the A train.
And spit on B?
No. B was pregnant. They were waiting for the A train, and Lewis got into it with the train conductor.
Oh, yeah.
And the guy was like talking shit, and Lewis is just filling his mouth with a loogie while
the whole time the guy's like, it's like a ghetto ass, like, MTA employee.
It's my favorite just, spit story.
He's in the window. Like, he, yeah, you know,
he's a conductor.
Blah, blah, motherfucker, blah, blah. It's an MTA employee. The whole time I'm just looking at him like I'm angry, but I'm not angry. I'm literally doing the thing where you suck your glands to make your mouth fill with as much spit as possible. So I'm like,
did you do any of those? Did you give any?
No, right at the end. No. So it goes, bing bong, and I go, boom, and it was like a fucking blast onto his face,
dude. Oh, then the hot. Train goes.
Then the train just goes, and he's like, blah.
Best thing I've ever heard.
Why did you get a fight with the conductor?
He wasn't conducting himself.
Have you ever been angry and someone film you, Bobby? Has anyone ever put a phone in your face when you're angry?
You know that answer.
I don't. I genuinely don't.
You
I've
know that
so,
answer.
No, I've smoked so much weed, I don't remember it.
Kevin did that to me.
Oh, well, yeah.
I didn't
like
that because
you're shtick.
I don't give a fuck.
He was recording the conversation. He wasn't filming.
That's for his
right?
podcast. No, that's content.
No. I was talking. We were over in the Pussycat Lounge when that was the green room for all the clubs during COVID. And I was sitting there talking about something. And I look and I turn around. The camera's just in my face. And he's talking to his fans, which bugged me. Here's Robert, you know, that shit. Like and I just grabbed his phone out of his phone.
Not allowed to do that. This is a problem with Colton and Kelly. They have a real
issue. Phone grab.
A real phone grabbing issue.
They don't know the rule that you're not allowed to grab phones. Yeah. That happened to me when we were in the mountains in Colorado, me and my friends, and we were going to our friend's funeral. Our friend Luke died, and we were like driving. All right. And we're at Starbucks. And
fucking Mountain Luke.
Yeah. My friends went in to get coffees. And I parked in a Tesla charge station. There were like 10 of them.
Yeah.
And I was just in a regular car. They were all empty. I just pulled in. And then I look in my rearview mirror and this guy's taking pictures of my license plate. And I roll down my window and I'm like, what are you doing? And he's like, I'm getting your license plate. You're not supposed to park here.
Oh.
And I go, you're a fucking nerd.
Yeah.
And he was like, you're not supposed to park here. You're not supposed to park here. And then I got out of the car and he started filming. And he's like, what are you going to do? And I was like, you're a fucking dork, dude. And my friend had no idea what was going on. Yeah. But I was like laughing, talking shit to him. I go, you're a grown man and you're this big of a pussy? And he's like, he was doing that laugh. And my friend Danny walks up with a tray of coffees and he goes, like that, thinking we're like being friendly. My friend Danny just walks up and he goes, like that. And the guy goes, your friend's funny. And he goes, he is, right? And then he sees how angry I am, and he goes, Soder, get in the car. Because I was like, you fuck. I was doing the thing where you guys both turned, where I was like, I'll fucking kill
you. There's a thing where somebody's like, you see this happen a lot, where like, it's a person videotaping another person.
Yeah.
And you don't know the context before. Yeah. But no matter what, the person who's being videotaped, if you start charging them like a lunatic, you do not look good at all. And that would be me.
You can't get mad.
You literally have to be like, oh, cool. You have to just take it. Because if you start running it, because they're backing up.
Yeah. Dude, he was literally, Danny was in Starbucks getting the coffee. And he's like, I saw the moment you got out of the car and the guy watched you unfurl. That's what he called it. Because I stood up and the guy went, oh, okay.
You know, the whole Kevin thing was.
Yeah.
I mean, he says all this. I don't give a shit what he says. I don't care. Fucking say whatever you want. It doesn't matter. But it was, now you're fucking. I'm not your content.
Yeah.
You know, and you don't know what the fuck I was saying. I was talking to Esty. This is like the comics where we hang and we're safe.
Yeah.
And you're being some fanboy.
You should have taken his phone and plugged your dates, been like, RobertKellyLive.com, dude.
I reacted. Whatever. It was stupid.
Have you ever been filmed? Getting mad?
I filmed a comedy special that you can watch right now. And where's my
camera? That's how you plug.
And by the way, probably going to be better than the last one.
Damn.
Thank you. That's very nice of you to say. I appreciate that. Yours is going to be better than every special I've ever seen.
And if you've been with us since day one, you've just watched constant improvement. Look at this kumbaya shit.
It couldn't be worse.
Anthony Kumbaya.
Anthony Kumbaya. That's good.
I like that.
No, I got a photo taken of me, two teenagers years ago. They took a photo. They were like, and took a photo of me.
What were they like?
That makes me good.
Whoa.
What the fuck?
I have Tourette's.
Yeah, but
I just got it diagnosed.
Do you go Japanese? You have Japanese Tourette's?
That's fucked up.
What's fucked up about that? What's gross to you about Japanese culture?
I have a mental illness.
Settle down.
No, Bobby. Play the kickback. Being a Japanese person, he bring a dishonor. A great dishonor. Sorry, guys. When I yell, I go Japanese.
But it's not a great story. This is like when I get tricked into telling a story that's not great.
I know.
And then we're all going to be like, bomb Dan,
I'm a
fan.
Yeah. I'm like, they took a photo.
That's
and
the
I was
beauty
like,
of this dance.
I was like, hey, I don't know. I don't like that.
All set up.
And then I fucked both of them at the same time.
Damn.
Yeah.
Damn. Were you fucking one and sucking the other?
Yeah. Sucked them off.
Yeah, but I know that you're not supposed to grab somebody's phone. Yeah. But there has to be some type of repercussion.
Conor McGregor, look that story up. Conor McGregor got it and like destroyed a phone and he got taken to court and shit.
DiPaolo did that first time I ever opened for him.
That's
guy
a great story.
Looked up his, picked up his phone and DiPaolo took it out of the front. He was in the front row. He just picked it up and put it in his drink, like his rum and coke, like in a pint glass.
Yeah.
And then he just did the whole show drinking with the guy's phone.
So funny.
And then the guy showed up the next night with a bill for like an $800 phone. DiPaolo gave him $300.
Worth it.
Yeah. It was
so funny just to take it and drop it in your fucking... arrested and jailed after he allegedly smashed a fan cell phone in Miami.
Allegedly, Bobby, favorite word.
There it is.
I'm a big
word of the day.
Yeah, you can't smash people's phones. You're not allowed to do that.
I didn't smash it. I just took it, and I said,
technically, you're a criminal.
I said, delete it.
Chris delete it.
There it is. Right. Ah, look at these. Yeah. God, touch dicks, dude. Get herpes.
I just realized how Joe's mind works now.
Now you can control him. You guys are going to watch me play Joe. You just say stuff you know he's going to pun off of.
But if somebody's maliciously recording you to trigger you, it's hard not to get triggered.
Yeah.
It's hard.
Yeah, you feel like
it's just they're doing it specifically to make you fucking angry, and you're like,
you just got to sit there and be like,
I love this.
Is that a Samsung?
I got fucking banned from my Equinox.
What?
I'm wearing the shirt. I was gonna do a gag where I wear an Equinox shirt.
Can we turn on that AC? I'm gonna turn on the AC.
Slater?
It's hot as shit.
Go ahead, turn it on.
We have
a guy do it.
Why did you get banned from Equinox?
I'll talk loud. Listen to it turn on.
That's actually why I got banned from Equinox. Other men talking loud.
Oh, wait, I remember the story.
No, lay it on me. I haven't heard this one.
Are
you banned from all Equinox?
All Equinox.
That was your shit. That's where you go steam.
It's part of my identity.
I was.
I'm you welcome at everyone.
You worked there, didn't you?
I worked there. I used that in my defense.
Oh, my God.
I'm still a member. I have the international membership. I can go to anyone.
Yeah, I did too, dude. I did as well.
No, you didn't. You told me I was stupid for getting
that. Oh, you had the destination.
Yes.
I'm a member of Anytime Fitness in Elmsford.
That's embarrassing. Cut that out.
I love that.
I don't want people to know Bobby. Weight Watchers or whatever the fuck it's called.
It's Anytime Fitness.
Fucking Bobby's a member of Jack LaLanne, you fucking old lady.
I just sit in a machine.
Jiggle things. Because if I drink my shake and I do my jiggles, I lose all my weight.
I have a shake for breakfast, a shake for lunch, and a sensible dinner.
And a jiggle.
So you're at Equinox. You're home away from home.
My home away from home. I've been going there for years. My last day job. I mean, it wasn't Equinox. I had another gym job, but like my last real day job that I had was Equinox. And I remember when I left, I was like, when I'm making enough money in comedy, I will get an Equinox membership. And I was very proud of myself for being able to get one. I've been a longtime member. It was a big deal to me. I've talked about for years what a great company Equinox is.
To nauseam.
Ad nauseum.
That one too.
Not to nauseum.
It's also not ad to nauseum.
It's allegedly.
Nauseam. Bobby, did you hear me use that word and then try to use it a minute?
To nauseum.
I said ad nauseum. Yeah. And then he goes, to
nauseum, dude.
It's like when a little kid hears a word and they're like. Yeah, I remember when I was little and my aunt used the word barely, and then I like walked over and I was like, well, that barely happened. And they go, that's not what that means.
And then Dan was like, barely legal porn.
Everyone knows I love big titted MILFs. Please.
I'm about to have one in my house. Aruga. So anyways, what's the dumb story?
Did her boobs get big?
I'd rather not talk about my wife's bosoms.
All right. We'll talk about it.
You'll call them a bosom unless they're fucking heavy.
Yeah, dude.
Mom bombs.
Mom bombs are sick.
Remember the time you brought B's breast milk in?
And we all drank.
Yeah.
We all drank.
And we're like, we're going to see if we can do a taste test. The difference between almond milk, regular milk, and breast milk. And only one tastes like human being.
One, I was like, this is a lot of protein.
Human being? Make...
Hey.
You knew how his brain works. You saw that coming.
Ah, shit, dude. I should have
seen that. You should have seen that coming.
Damn it.
So you're at Equinox. You had a good steam.
In the steam room. There's three other guys in the steam room.
You guys are body on body.
No, there's three guys in the steam room, and they're talking. They're having a loud conversation. And I'm trying to relax. Steam room etiquette is...
Sucking dick or quiet.
Don't be an asshole.
Keep your mouth full.
What?
Don't be a fucking asshole. For me. You know I don't suck dick.
No. Yeah.
Well, that's why then you've never used the steam room.
Yeah, you don't use it correctly.
So here he was, steaming right into my mouth. These guys were talking loudly.
Was it a business conversation, casual conversation?
Business casual? Like they were talking about where they were taking their boats that weekend?
Was it middle-aged guys or older dudes?
It was actually three different generations of men. There was a 35-year-old, like a 50-year-old, and then like a 70-year-old.
There was a father, a son, and then a
Holy
grandson.
Spirit. Mm-hmm. So,
so you guys are bummed there. It is. Throw it over. So they're having a conversation about where they're going to take their boat.
They're just talking shit in the steam room. And what they're doing is, if you've ever been into a steam room, have you guys steamed
every day?
Yeah. You steam.
I'm going right after this.
Okay, Joe.
Wait, go to the bath.
I go to Equinox.
Oh, I go to the Russian bath.
I'll go to Russian bath with you.
I will. Let's do it next week.
I'm 100%.
We'll do it Monday.
Love it.
Never gonna happen. Guarantee they don't go.
So Joe,
We're gonna.
I'll bet $1,000.
We're gonna go.
$1,000. $500. Don't go.
And we're gonna steam.
Yeah, $1,000. We're in
on Monday.
All right, done.
All right.
So they're doing the thing, and Joe, you'll know this when the steam starts to dissipate.
Yes.
You cheat, right? You take a little bit of water, you throw it onto the fucking sensor.
Yeah. I don't think that's cheating. I think that's just how it works.
It's not really how it works. You're not supposed to do that.
Yeah, you're not supposed to do that.
You're not supposed to do that. The idea is that the air temperature has cooled so much that it triggers it. You don't get to just fucking go, it's not hot enough for me, right? And if you do that.
You ask permission.
You go to everyone in the steam room, you go, hey guys, you mind if I hit the steam again? Yeah. It's going to make it hotter. That's just simple fucking etiquette.
Sure.
I mean, you're having a conversation. You do it in a very low.
How do you? We're on the steam room. Show us how I do it. We're on the steam room.
I'm back. I was like.
Hold on.
What's it? Yo, dude, I'm next. I love that.
You gonna give me that? You gonna give me it?
Go ahead.
Hey, do you guys mind if I hit the sensor?
Yeah,
no.
I'm sucking. I'm good.
I'd like that.
No, it's actually good sucking steam right here.
Great. Nobody ever says no to that.
Never.
Nobody ever says no, but you still ask.
Yeah.
Because maybe it is too hot. And by the way, I have said no to be a cunt.
It's like sexy women.
Have you folded your arms and gone, no?
No, it's hot enough. I've said that before. Because I've been like, well, because it'll be people that abuse it and they go, psst. And then as soon as the steam goes off, they go again. You're like, well, it is actually too hot.
And I've been there many times where people come in from outside and just immediately start dumping.
No way.
We're all here.
Yeah. Ooh.
They don't even check in.
They don't check.
Is it not rude as fuck?
It's obnoxious.
Now imagine they were also having a loud conversation. Three guys having a loud conversation.
So you're already mad.
So I'm sitting there. I'm annoyed about the loud conversation. They're just loud, just full volume, as loud as we are right now, having a fucking conversation. So I'm kind of sitting there like, fucking annoyed. Like, and I'm trying to ignore it. But then the one guy. He keeps on getting up and hitting the fucking steam thing. Now the steam is coming out louder. They have to talk louder to be over the steam. So they're fucking yelling at each other. And I'm getting more annoyed so that it goes off again. Then right away, not asking anybody. They're yelling about their boats.
My favorite part of the story, by the way.
Yelling about their fucking boats. Here I am.
God damn.
So then I go in a very polite tone.
Wait a minute.
Now, is this a Lewis polite tone? Or
I don't have a playback.
Is this a Dan polite, a Joe Good polite, thing. A me polite, or your polite?
Is it mild, medium, spicy, extra spicy?
As I'm replaying this in my head, I may have yelled.
Yeah. They go like, yeah, no, we're going to the boat. It's fun.
Yeah.
And then out of the steam, you just hear Lewis go, well, you fucking pussies. Stop steaming.
Doggy, if I hit again, I'm fucking killing everyone.
He goes, actually, no, it's funny. The thing about a schooner is you have to, excuse me, sir. So you go like, what do you say?
How do you
say?
Very politely.
All right, I'm the guy.
You're the guys. You're the three guys.
All right, we're the guy. Hey, yeah.
You're the 70-year-old.
I'm the 35-year-old.
35-year-old, and you're the 50-year-old.
Hey, right. So listen, what you want to do
yes.
when you get your boat, you want to get the jibby, the mast up.
Yes,
I mean, right? I mean, mm-hmm. the mast.
Hey, guys.
I don't think we could say jib on the air.
Yeah. Jibbies.
That's going to get you in trouble, dude.
Hey, guys, would you mind? I'm just trying to relax over here. If we could just keep it
I'm sorry.
Bit.
We'll collect the towels outside the steam room. Help doesn't speak to us while we're steaming.
Yeah, this isn't Monday help day.
Yeah.
And we're white?
Do one of you guys know Spanish?
So, no, I was like, hey, guys. And I said it very respectfully. I was like, hey, could you guys like keep it down a little? I'm trying to relax over here. You guys are talking very loud.
Si, senora. Yeah.
So you say that, and who's the
You
shit?
Say it like that, though. You say it like that.
Middle guy, he goes, he's like, he kind of sits there for a minute, for like a beat.
Yeah.
And then he goes.
That's when you know shit's coming.
He goes, is there like a rule against talking in the steam room? And then I was like.
That's fair.
Joe, that's your line. Go ahead.
I think that's fair.
Give it to him.
Is there a rule against talking in the steam room?
That's fair.
No, there's not. But it's just like etiquette. I'm trying to relax. You guys can talk. I was like, it's just you're being a little bit loud. So if you could just keep it down, I'm trying to like just be in my own space over here.
Oh, I didn't know that we. We couldn't talk a certain...
Listen, old man, stay the fuck out of it.
Whoa.
Excuse me,
Whoa.
That's my daddy.
Whoa.
My daddy. Oh. My daddy. Daddy can talk to whoever he wants. His heart hurts. No, my old lover's heart. You stupid fucking...
Sons,
you island Mexican. You just hurt my daddy's heart.
New York's not what it used to be.
Oh, God. A bathhouse used to be a place that three gay men could go fuck each other and get AIDS.
Whoa. Too far.
So that's it.
Cut it.
That was the extent of.
And then you got kicked out forever.
I'm going to tell you. That's not it. That's it of that interaction.
Okay.
If you know Lewis, and I've been with him a couple times in public, where all of a sudden I become his wife, and I just have to hold the kids back.
Yeah.
Daddy will be within a sec. He's taking care of it. It escalates.
They leave the steam room. Yeah. Okay. And they go out and they're shaving. Now, I'm still in the steam room.
Are they really shaving in the steam room?
No, they're shaving in the sink area.
That's a strike.
That's crazy. That's fucking
people
crazy.
Do that.
I know.
People shave in the steam room?
Wild.
Sickening.
Yeah. That's disgusting.
Probably good for your skin. But
nobody has any understanding of the etiquette of a fucking steam room
I completely
anymore.
Agree. I could go on myself.
They leave fucking towels on the floor.
And they leave those
garb.
Paper cups. They fill up the paper cups to throw in the thing, and they leave a pile of paper cups.
Why do we pay $500 a month for a gym?
Yeah.
I pay $39.99 for Anytime Fitness.
Anytime. It's got one machine. It's just a Bowflex.
Anytime
just six guys in fucking Westchester waiting to use a Bowflex.
Shit. Six Mexican waiters.
Yeah.
Excuse me, sir. My turn to do the pull-ups.
Uno more, Paco.
So
I like you better when you were big.
So now another guy's in the steam room. Now these guys all leave. Now I go to that guy. I'm like, fucking guys, right? And he's like, I know, right? We were on the same page.
God, okay. You guys were born to fuck each other.
Dude. So then I get out. To go shave my head. Now it's all bald guys. Everyone's shaving their heads. The visual here is all bald guys in towels. Everyone's shaving their heads. I go to lather up my head. Right, 35-year-old. Your line. He goes, "Hey, what's your name?
Hey, what's your name? How do you say it? Did he go? Did he say it like a little kid? Where he goes, "Hey, what's your name?
Yeah, give him some.
Hey, mister.
Hey, mister. Are you about to shave your head? Hey, what's your name?
No, he goes. He's like,
"Hey, what's your name?
Lewis, why?" And then he goes,
"I've never sucked a Lewis. I've never tasted a Lewis."
No, he goes, he's like, "I want to know who told me to shut the fuck up in the steam room."
Oh, dog, can I ask you, just as your friend, I've been your friend for damn near 20 years.
Please.
did your fight boner get rock hard at that moment? You've been waiting.
No.
You didn't have any moment.
I'll tell you the moment.
Because I know, Lewis.
There's a moment.
We've just watched you sweat like a pro wrestler.
There's a moment.
There wasn't a moment.
I'm already sweating because I'm in the steam room. They don't understand that that's not anger.
Yeah.
They don't get the trigger. Yeah, you're already there.
They don't know that the tail is... They can't hear the rattle. The rattle. It's been rattling since they've been in the steam room. They have no idea what's coming.
Ah, shit. So... He goes, yeah, I wonder who told me to shut the fuck up. And then I said, I'm still being very respectful. I was like, I didn't tell you to shut the fuck up. I was very respectful.
Yeah.
And then middle guy, 50-year-old, goes, nah, you weren't respectful. He like, now they're both coming in at me like fucking.
Where am I? Am I still blowing guys?
He's gone. The 70-year-old, he's sort of not really in it. It's these two.
He's
fuckers.
Putting on a dress shirt with a sweater over it.
Yeah.
A sweater vest.
No, these two are coming at me like fucking velociraptors.
Yeah.
They're
hunting packs.
These two, so then my back's against
primarily
the wall. My back's against
allegedly.
The wall.
Allegedly.
I hate if this episode isn't called allegedly, we're fucking up. So they're coming at you. One raptor's over here.
Yeah. So then he's like, yeah, I wonder who told me to shut the fuck up. I was like, I was respectful. And he goes, you weren't respectful. I was like, oh. So I was like, all right, so now I'm telling you to shut the fuck up.
Nice.
Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. Do you have something else to fucking say, pussy? And he's like, looking at me. I was like, don't even fucking look at me, bitch.
Yeah.
Avert your fucking eyes, you little fucking bitch. Both of you are like, and I'm getting fucking wild.
Yeah.
Wow. People are coming around. People are coming around the corners. God, I know why you're coming.
Now I know why you fuck so much, dude.
This
is getting me.
Oh, Jersey.
This is Paramus.
This is getting my balls.
This is Paramus. So then, and then I was like, yeah, fuck it. I remember I said, avert your eyes, bitch. And then he looked down, too. Pussy, dude.
Do you think he went home that night when he was eating his wife's meatloaf? He goes, you know, another man made me feel lesser than today. I was made to feel lesser.
Did he look away?
He looked away.
He looked down?
Yeah.
Ugh. Damn.
Like a bitch.
This is what made me change my mind a little on the gun argument. Because without guns, Lewis just gets to dominate the planet. Like,
I can also get a gun.
With a gun, I get to make a whole mall feel my wrath.
I'm not even kidding. You, Dan, too soon. Edit.
I'm from Colorado. I'm just letting you know. A couple things go bad. Get ready for your boy to spray some shit.
No, people got to have guns. I'm going to get a gun.
Why?
For Lewis only.
Dude, that's so funny. Joe, the second Lewis comes up, he just goes right to
just
it.
Shoots one of my knee.
He goes, guys, I just need to have my hand.
The
on.
Next Regz episode, you two start jawing.
Joe has a jacket and shows he's wearing a shoulder holster.
So what? When the guy looked down, you made one guy avert his eyes.
I made him avert his eyes.
What'd the other guy do?
He averted his fucking eyes, too.
They both looked down like fucking dogs?
Because they don't have guns.
They both knew not to say another fucking word or it was about to get fucking real. And at that point, I was like, all right, I have won. I was going by Lewis rules. These are Gomez rules. Like, I have won. Do I get a reward?
In his head, he goes, Lewis, point.
So if they look away, you win.
I won. Yeah, I literally got back.
I can understand those rules. Out of all the crazy shit Lewis thinks, I can understand these
rules. I went back in the steam room. I went back. I swear to God.
You did?
I went back in the steam room. I was like, cool, they averted their fucking eyes. My job here is done.
Let me steam this celebration.
Yes.
Lewis thinks he's a vigilante.
I love it.
So then I go to leave, and I go to, like, 20 minutes later, I'm done with, like, my steam and my stuff, right? I'm assuming they're long gone, so I'm going to leave. And the front desk girl, she goes, bye, Lewis. And I was like, why does she know my name? Like, was she just talking to somebody about me?
Okay.
It was weird. So then
anybody
like,
else that would be a friendly little
no,
thing?
They would not. She would not have just known my name like that.
That is weird that she goes, goodbye.
Well, she could be
Lewis.
A fan.
No, and you go in to touch the door and you go, how do you?
No. I was like, no, I knew immediately. I was like, these fucking pussies.
Snitch ass pussies.
Snitched on me. They averted pussies. Their eyes and they went straight to the fucking manager.
You Cesar Milan, you dominated them and then they fucking snitched.
But how do they know it was you? Is there a camera or do they describe you?
He said his name.
Yeah.
I know, but like, how
he goes,
do they...
what's your name? I want to know who
no,
told me to shut the fuck up.
That,
I said,
dumb
I am Lewis.
I know that, but how did they relay that to her where she knew your name?
They were...
I'm going to tell you, they went to the front desk and said, oh, we were attacked by a
There's
brown
a brown
person.
Man named Lewis.
That's what
screaming
I was
in the locker room. Many people can corroborate the story.
Excellent word.
Yeah.
Bobby will be using that in under 60 seconds.
Yeah.
He goes, do you guys want to corroborate on this live read?
I can corroborate that this really happened.
He's like, I'm one of the best fucking corroborators in the world, yeah, dude. I work with so many people.
Allegedly.
Yeah, allegedly.
I'm allegedly. I corroborate to nauseam.
So she says goodbye, Lewis, and you like.
And I was like, fuck.
They asked his name because they had, this was the. They asked his name because they were going to rat
They were going to rat me out the whole
That
time.
Was the whole plan.
Of course.
Let's go rat this fucking asshole out. Because
they're pussies.
Yeah,
because they're fucking pussies, dude. Yeah. They don't just fight in the locker room like men. We could have handled it all in the locker room like men.
You guys could have had an Eastern Promises nude fight.
That was a good one.
There's a bunch of that.
That's a good pull.
So then I was like, all right, let me call the manager of the club. Let me call the club because I'm leaving. I was like, let me get ahead of it.
You want to corroborate your story.
I want to corroborate my story.
There it is.
Robert Kelly.
Hey.
That's a Joe List joke right there.
By the way, you brought genuine joy to Joe's face.
I like
If you saw that, he went like this. Yeah.
By the way, let's not act like Lewis hasn't been doing these for 10 years also.
These are also bad puns. You're right. Yeah. I've been doing bad puns for a long time.
Yeah.
Allegedly.
Allegedly. So.
Allegedly.
So.
Allegedly Roy Brown.
I call the club. And I'm like, I was like, yeah, I was just attacked in the locker room by these men. Of course. I was like, yeah, they came at me. There was three of them. They were like velociraptors. Dude, I love
you.
An allergy.
I love you getting into character at home. You go, help, help. They attacked me.
Yeah. I also love your version of getting ahead of it is just spinning the story that they attacked you.
What did the manager say?
She's like, oh my God, I'm so sorry this happened. Let's find out what happened. We'll get back to you. And then 2 days later, that was the assistant manager. The manager called me back. She was like, yeah, there was multiple witnesses. You were being a fucking savage animal in the locker room. And yeah, we're going to take away your membership.
Forever.
You're forever banned.
Forever.
Wow.
Now, what if I
you
want to
become
a
member
guest
of Anytime Fitness?
No. I joined Lifetime Fitness, like an adult.
Dude, Anytime.
Lifetime.
You know why Anytime
the movie
Fitness?
Channel?
Do you know Anytime Fitness is
yes.
good?
I joined the American Movie Classics gym.
I joined Oxygen Network.
In Midtown.
Lewis.
Hey, you Lewis. Guys want to go work out at VH1 gym?
Do you know why Anytime Fitness is good?
Because it's a made-up place?
No, cause it's not. It's not, Dan.
I'm at MTV, the gym.
I want my steam room.
Anytime Fitness is good because it's anytime.
Yeah, 24, 24 right?
hours.
Most.
I get my own key, my little key fob, and I can just go in.
You know what's crazy is I have a key fob nice. Too for a gym.
What
in
gym?
In my building.
Yeah, whatever.
I got a gym.
Successful
in my
wife.
Is she the breadwinner now?
She's always been the breadwinner, dog.
Really?
Yeah. Go a little Google. She signed a deal with ESPN that's doing all right by your boy.
Yeah. Damn. She's got that flirting guy with her. I don't like it.
Excuse me?
The baseball player.
Hunter Pence.
I told you before. I don't care for it.
Hunter Pence?
Yeah, that's right.
Former World Series great?
That's right. They're on the air together. I watched the whole game. He's like, oh, Katie, that's great.
He touched your leg?
Thank you.
No.
He touched
your leg?
But I don't like the vibe.
Don't start that. And that was last season.
I don't like the energy.
They haven't spoke since last season.
I'm not starting anything. I just don't like the vibe.
You know I'm a Giants fan. Why are you doing this?
I don't know.
Why did he touch your leg?
He didn't touch her leg. That's a made-up story.
He kissed her on the cheek.
What?
He did not.
On air?
He did no such thing.
Two in the pink, one in the stink.
Stop it. He sent
right on the air. Just
he sent, and I went, oh my God, this is on Apple Plus.
I don't let any men that are better than me around my wife.
Sarah's like, I'm not allowed to talk to anybody.
The only one she talks to is run on.
That's something we can all get behind. Shitting on people that aren't here.
Bob had a bone to pick. Oh, that's your other podcast.
The fuck was that?
You had a bone to pick.
What are you talking about?
You had a bone to pick.
What do you mean?
Because some fan made some art and you hated the art.
What?
Oh, yeah. You said we had a topic for the show.
Well, they made a...
One topic, one direction, one rule.
This is it right here. You know what?
I'm the forgotten rat pack?
No, you know what? I'm fine with this.
Suck my dick.
No, you're
fine
Peter Lawford. I know who
I mean,
he is.
First of all,
who he is.
Joe...
It made my science hair look great, though.
I think Dan should be Sammy Davis.
I love that.
Joe should be the guy that we don't know.
No.
I should be Frank Sinatra. And Lewis is Dean.
I think
Bobby,
I should be Dino.
You're centered. I think I should be Sammy because he's a Jew and I have the most Jewish qualities.
I'm the guy everyone forgot about.
Except for money. I really throw the money around. Bobby had ads for years and didn't pay us, so maybe he should be the Jew.
I didn't make money. Damn.
You know what, Jew?
You know what, Jew?
You know what, Jew?
Ah, you got your bris. You know what, Jew?
You got your dreidel.
First of all, you guys all left me. Did your own podcasts.
I did a radio
show. Yeah, because we needed to. Yeah.
And then I handed
we need to sustain a life.
Bobby,
we need to go make some money so we can live lives.
I did a radio show, and then you took it, so we're even.
But you fucking gave it to me.
Yeah, I gave it to you, and then as I hugged you, I said, "We're even."
By the way, the word isn't big enough. You got to have that much bigger. Other than that, I kind of like it.
You like? You want to use this as our cover art?
I'm actually fine with this. I don't. I'll be Dean. I don't mind being Dean, but I thought I was actually Sammy.
I don't know who any of these fucking people are.
That's Frank.
Because I'm not a fucking old white bitch.
You're not an old Ginzo.
You don't know who Frank Sinatra is?
Bring this shit to fucking Calta and Kelly.
Damn.
Oh, and they gave Bobby a cigar. Oh, they gave us all cigars. Actually, Dan looks a little bit like Dave Smith in this photo.
I think that's what they wanted.
It's a better podcast, Dave instead of Dan.
Oh, my God. He'd have so many knowledgeable
libertarian points.
Oh, he'd have so many points about government staying out of your business.
Yeah. It's like, dude, I'm on nobody's side. Libertarians really are like the goth kids from South Park.
Everything is dark. Everything is pain. Government is pain. That's libertarians.
Libertarians just sit out of gym class. They're like, this is stupid. I'm not participating.
Taxes are so lame. Their bangs over their faces. Yeah. Less government, more land. And then the other two sides are retarded.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let's do a read.
We don't do the read. We do the read at the end, right?
Do it at the end? Well, it's a mid-roll.
Go ahead, Dan.
Oh!
Go ahead, Dan. We got a sponsor.
Oh!
I'm the only person who even knows this sponsor yet.
Yeah.
Sheath. Can I get some Sheath?
I want some Sheath.
I love Sheath. I'm wearing Sheath right now.
Are you wearing Sheath? Me too.
I'm wearing Manscaped.
I'm wearing...
Say that?
I'm wearing...
I could say that.
Look at this. Sheath, baby.
Sheath.
Give me some Sheath and I'll wear it.
What's the difference between... Why is this...
Sorry,
so good?
I shave my balls.
Why is this so good?
Damn, you wore the promotional underwear that came with your Manscaped package.
No, Bert gave me a bunch in my gift bag. You have it, too.
Oh, Do not mention Bert again.
Don't bring that name
up. Dude, he just...
We cannot!
Joe just fucking punched
him
down.
I cannot! We have a bitter rivalry.
Read the thing.
No.
Ohio State, Michigan, Kreischer list.
Dan should not read the thing. Dan doesn't... Me and Joe should be talking about it because these are the best fucking underwear in the world.
I don't even need to read it.
You know what?
Read.
Throw it away. Fuck it.
Throw it away.
It was invented by Robert Patton, U.S. Army soldier who fought in Iraq. He invented it in Iraq because his balls and dick kept sticking to each other. So he invented his own underwear with a pouch for the balls and a pouch for the dick.
It segregates your dick and balls.
What if your dick is inside your balls?
If you have a really small dick, you can wear them as regular underwear.
Okay, great.
No, he's fucking awesome. Sheath Underwear is literally all I wear. I can't wait to see him at Skankfest.
I'm dead ass. They're sponsors of Skankfest. And all bullshit is, we were supposed to say it, but without a doubt, the most comfortable underwear you wear.
Absolutely.
The dual pouch technology is awesome. It makes you look like you have a package. I have a small dick and balls.
No, you don't.
I do.
Dude, let me tell you right now. You're an excellent lover.
Thank you.
And you've said that several times.
Thank you. But my dick and balls aren't great, and when I wear Sheath, they look fucking great.
I have a great dick, but it's not a great shower. Like, it's kind of...
Of course. But dude, I'm telling you right now, they look fucking incredible. They have all these different styles.
So you don't need to hang?
Nope. Moisture wicking technology. Okay. It's just the most comfortable underwear that you're going to wear. Anybody who wears them, they don't go back to wearing any other underwear. I have 100 pair of Sheath at home. That's all I fucking wear. I do not wear anything.
Can you get me some?
I'll bring you some this week.
If you go to sheathunderwear.com right now, I'm telling you, you can get a 20% off if you use code word REGZ, REGZ. 20% off at sheathunderwear.com, promo code REGZ right now.
That's one-fifth. Oh, by the way, chicks, they make good sports bras and booty shorts.
They do.
We like this stuff so much, we're going longer than we need to.
Yeah. They only contracted us for like 30 seconds. We're just fucking talking shit.
We love it.
Yeah, they sent my chick a bunch of shit. It looks fucking great. You want to see her in it, Bob?
Yeah.
I do.
Come on.
Dude.
We lost Soder. How much time do we have left? He's on the phone.
Soder's fucking...
Soder, what's going on, dude?
I'll tell you what's going on, guys. Sheath Underwear's got a deal
going on. We're over. We're done.
We finished it.
That reminds me of my idea. I want to bring you in for it. You want to hear my idea for like a video? It's WWFAA. And it's like sobriety quotes, but a wrestler.
I knew I had a problem when I woke up. Yeah, I was alone. Dead alone. Yeah. And there it was. Reality.
Like that?
You're a brilliantly talented person.
Thanks, yeah,
dude.
You shouldn't be here.
You know what's great? I love being surrounded by other brilliantly talented people.
Aw.
And that was the bonfire. No, I was kidding. No, but I
didn't care for the amount of pause in between the just kidding.
No,
felt like we're going to start a fight.
I am so fucking proud.
As though we can't take a ribbon.
I'm so fucking proud of, for the 10 years we've been doing this show, it's so cool to see where everything is. Your special's out today.
on YouTube.
Don't overdo it, Dan.
Dude,
yeah,
that was
fucking
a good
asshole.
Yeah, you're overdoing it.
Right. He's overdoing it.
Yeah, okay. You're overdoing
you know what? Then fuck all.
We got it. We've moved on.
I got a podcast coming out in November. Now that.
Don't tell fucking Jay that.
I did. I already talked
to him. I'm kidding. Oh, okay. Whatever.
I'm Jay.
Dude.
He said it would bother him if it was twice a week.
That's hilarious.
Is that what it is?
No.
How many days?
Dude, it's 45 minutes once a week.
Once a week. Wow. And you didn't even take that meeting with me. Remember when I said I wanted to
do it? I still haven't had it. Yeah. I still, by the way, I haven't locked in anything.
Okay. You said you're starting a podcast in November.
Yeah.
Don't sounds like you've locked something in.
Are you dance with me, baby.
Are you going to go to Gas Diligent? We heard it here first.
I'm not.
Yeah. Wow.
What? I'm going to go
new show, Gas Diligent.
I'm building my
YouTube
channel.
That's awesome.
But I'm going to talk to Lewis. I'm still going to have a cup of coffee with him.
Talk to me and tell me that he's not bringing a show to Gas Digital.
Are you going to Gas Digital?
I'm building my YouTube page. You guys have been building your YouTube
just so you know, it goes on your YouTube page, even if it's on Gas
Digital. Let's have a cup of coffee.
Let's have a cup.
Why do you have to
have a cup of coffee?
Why?
Yeah, cuck of coffee.
Just say yes now. Just say yes.
No, I'm not saying yes now. I'm not even being bullied.
I also told Dan. I told Dan that we would preemptively pay him for all the ad reads that he could have.
I have nothing that's on my own. So I got to talk to Lewis because I don't know what this is.
Okay.
I'm going in blind. I don't know what we're talking about.
As someone that's put out 3 YouTube specials, all bangers.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Especially the new one.
Yeah. Thank you.
Out now.
This is hard. This is hard. This
like
is
my,
really
just like
hard
my
to
fucking
do.
Fucking dick.
I love you guys all.
I'm going to put my special on YouTube, I think.
Nice.
So am I next year.
No, YouTube's the way to
go. Mine was on Louis for a while, and someone told me you should take it off Louis.
You shouldn't.
And throw it on
YouTube.
You've
got the money from it, so now put it up on YouTube so everyone can get
it. Yeah, it's free later.
Because as Bobby once famously said, and he's right about this, when I was opening for you, you fucking murdered. It's one of my favorite things. I got on stage and go, Jesus Christ, Bobby, you fucking killed. And you go, I'm a hammer. I'm a hammer.
But here's the problem with my special. I can't look at it.
Because it looks like you in a fat suit.
It's uncomfortable for me to watch.
Oh, right.
I'm such a fat mess.
And that was the peak, right?
That was around 355.
Yikes.
That was a heavy Bobby.
One of our friends is getting his surgery soon, and I'm excited to watch him.
Do I know him?
No, but we need to put you in touch with him.
Really?
Could really help.
Is he a comic?
No.
Oh, he's just
a good friend of ours. Friend of Lewis's and I's.
There's a couple people that need to get
eyes.
Surgery.
Eyes. Dummy.
Allegedly, you're a fucking ass.
Yeah, I can't watch it.
Well, now Jay's on Ozempic, and you did the fucking stomach surgery.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But do you think Ozempic's working for Jay?
Have you seen a difference?
Yeah, a little bit.
Saw him at Metallica, his face.
Yeah, no, he's lost weight in his face. But here's the Ozempic thing. I'm just nervous with that because now they're coming up with all kinds of shit that you get stomach seizures and all stomach can't. All this fucking nausea.
I wouldn't take any drug that wasn't out for like 10 fucking years.
Dude.
It's a tough drug.
When I got LASIK, it was because it was out for 20 years. When I got the hair surgery, it's because they've been doing it for 20 years.
Yeah, dude. All that, all these fucking first fucking.
By the way, when I did Rogan.
Jane Christina to pull her teeth out. Like, what's going on?
They go, do you know you get fucking ear rot? They just pull their ears off. Dude, when I see guys that did the hair surgery in the 90s, and they have that fat fucking scar on the back of their head, mine looks like a paper cut.
Rogan has that.
Yeah.
Rogan has that.
He got it in the 90s.
Jamie Foxx. Has the tattoo in the back of his head because he did it.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Doing that, when I got it done, they were like, it's going to look like a fucking paper cut.
Yeah. Mm. They just took a square off the back of your head back
then. You had, wait, what did you have?
I had the hair surgery.
He's got a space wig.
I got fucking science hair, dude.
This isn't real hair?
No.
No, it's my
hair. His hair, but they
transplant. It's my hair from back here, and they put it up here.
Yeah.
And then this will grow back.
It's all back. It's
so, but
back.
That won't grow. That just always stays that.
No, it grows. It's my hair.
Your hair grows here?
Yeah.
How?
They implant.
Dude, I'm telling you right, it's the joke
of our
that I do
sponsor,
on stage.
Hairtransplant.com. 20%.
I got a space toupee, dude.
Yeah.
Dude.
Should I get hair again?
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
I'll give you the name, dude. I'll give you the name right now. I want Lewis coming back.
Long blonde hair.
I love it. I'm way on board with
toupee,
that.
Toupee, more like too gay.
Hey.
That was good.
Nice. Love it.
Thanks, guys.
That was good. I love you guys. We go through a thing.
It is a lot sometimes.
It's all, listen,
I'm excited for it to not be as hot
this
room.
This, we'll get a better AC.
Yeah.
This show has always been a fucking...
dude, this is it. This is the beginning
of
everything.
It's been a bomb ticking, and it might explode.
But that's the best part.
Yeah.
This is why it's fun.
Yeah.
It's like that game where you wind it up and you try to get all the pieces. And
you're I want to fight you.
Hey, Bobby, do you want to box
bad
after
idea.
This?
I would.
Let's just get some gloves on.
Can I say something? I can't today because I have Dan's old job to go to. But I will definitely.
How's my wife? How's your wife and my
100%.
Kids?
100%.
That was good. JoeListComedy.com. RobertKellyLive.com.
That's not my website.
Fuck you.
What are you
doing?
The
show's not done, Dan. Stop trying to wrap the show up.
I don't like
it. We have 20 minutes of show, dude.
Dan wants to go home.
Dan, chill.
And you know what? I'm a little concerned about you.
You know what?
Because it would have been 300 times funny if you threw that at me, and then you were gonna, and then you decided at the last second to throw it.
No,
next
I just,
to me.
I didn't.
No, you should have thrown it at me.
Don't
you
tell me what
up.
To do. I don't need notes.
I'm not saying what you should
do. Fight.
I mean, what you did.
No notes. No direction.
No rules.
One rule.
A lot of edits.
I still got a beef.
A lot of
edits.
I got a Bobby beef too. Remember the intro?
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. How does we go Bobby beefs?
That's a
Bobby Beef.
That's a sandwich store.
That's a good fucking sandwich store. Bobby's Beef.
Bobby's Beef.
Take down open DeRosa.
Put it right next to DeRosa's.
Oh my God.
Remember, I wasn't even in. Were you guys in the intro? It was like Amy Schumer and Norton were in
there
the intro.
No, Amy Schumer. You're out of your mind.
They used to be.
They used to be. Yeah, it was.
Remember when you
were.
They were
ads.
Do you remember when Bobby used to be
a
star fucker? Do you remember when Bobby would invite us to his house to barbecues?
You're taking it too
far. And then he would put us at another table.
It's not true. That's not true.
Fuck yeah.
It's not true.
Amy,
you know what? Lewis Schumer. Lewis,
you
were right.
You're an asshole.
You know what it was? It was our fucking. It was me, you, Joe, two guys. From Westchester,
Scopo
that he met in a fucking cigar store.
Yeah.
And then the other table,
it's
Colin, Keith,
yeah.
Amy.
Yep. And you guys came in and sat where you sat.
No. We had to eat our steak tips with a guy that fucking picks up the garbage.
You guys came in and sat where you sat.
No.
Oh, what do you want me to fucking, hey guys,
pull
hey Colin,
video.
Hey meet Dan. Dan meet Colin.
I had already opened for Colin by that time.
Doesn't matter.
I knew Colin.
You go sit next to him. I didn't have assigned seating. I had 60 chairs. Sit wherever you fucking insecure cowards.
I thought
listen. Went and sat over by yourselves.
I remember Bobby goes, if you currently have a movie with Judd Apatow, dude, you can sit at this table.
To be fair, I thought that Amy was a pig they were roasting, and I was like, I'm not gonna just sit right there. It's gonna get fucking.
Dude, you love. I remember you being like, "Hey, Amy,
yeah.
What's been going on?"
Hey, Amy, exactly.
You walked up, you went, "Amy, what's going on? What are you? You look great.
Hey, babe.
I remember sitting with Keith Robinson because he was particularly upset that he was covered in spiders because you had those wooden.
I had the.
He sat by the fire, and the fucking spiders came out of the wood.
We had
I had a tree cut down.
Yeah.
And I was like, "Hey, I'll keep these logs."
And then you're like, "Make the stools." You're like, "Make the black man sit on."
But I kept them too long, and they became spider. Homes.
Yeah, God damn it, Bobby, I got spiders all over me.
Yeah, remember, were you there when it
they
rained?
Say spider bites cause strokes.
And we had to go under the tent?
I had all the tents set up and then they broke. And you guys were just roasting me while I was cooking in the rain.
I remember that.
And then I think 55 of us had to go into my house.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Remember when you got the Ben and Jerry's show up?
Dude, we used to have good barbecues.
Max's birthday parties were bangers.
They were fucking great.
And I remember I came up with Lewis and James, and then I remember we went to the toy store to get Max a present, and I got James one. That was a solid move. I was like, hey, James.
You also got a toy. It's your birthday too today, kid.
I go, James, check the trunk. He was like,
you know who gave the best presents?
Who?
Dante.
Dante Nero?
Nero. Yeah. I feel bad because I never got his kid a thing.
Damn.
Well, he never had a party. He never had a
shit
thing.
What are you guys getting my kid? Something nice?
Yeah.
Yeah, a mouth extender.
We'll see. We got to wait.
That was good.
He's talking about his dick.
We have to, we have to wait and see.
Yeah. Hardy har har. Yeah. Everyone laugh it up. Real cool.
What do you mean, Dante? Dante gets the best gifts?
Where
did you get him?
Dude, Dante won you.
You got him a couple of bitches.
You got him a pinto.
He goes, this right here is a Polish bitch. You slap her around, little bitch. You suck your dick, Max. Max is like, I want to go pound the boingy. He goes, yeah. Listen, you got to control the bitch.
You got to learn to come before you can walk, son.
You
got
to grab her by the back of her neck.
He got him these two, they were like little blimps. One was they were a shark and a fish, but you could control them.
Like a drone.
Like, and they could just go around the house.
Dude.
And they would just go around the house. And then you could, it was like a drone. Yeah.
Favorite drone story of all time.
Yeah.
Big J used to have barbecues at Wayne's house for the 4th of July. This is like fucking 7 years ago.
It's also an insight as to how Big J's mind works. Wayne had barbecues.
Yeah.
So you guys know, Wayne had barbecues and
Jay invited everybody.
Jay invited all his friends.
So. It's like 7 years ago. Drones are barely being bought by
this
people.
This is maybe even more. This has to be a 10 years ago. This is when a small drone is like $800.
The story is
like
droning on.
That was good.
Thank you.
Ralph Sutton bought...
Out of my little stupid mouth.
Hey, stop.
It's small.
It is tiny.
Hopefully your kid doesn't get your mouth.
God bless him if he does. He's going to be... He's got whistle mouth. So Ralph Sutton.
We're cutting all this. Edit.
Ralph Sutton gets a drone. He's like the first person I've ever met with a drone. And he's at the barbecue and he's like, yeah, so this is the drone. It goes up and down like this. And then Lewis goes, can I see it? And he gets it, and Lewis is flying it, and I'm standing there watching the whole thing, and then Lewis goes, oh, this is fucking sick, and it's like going around, and then it just goes around a building, and Lewis goes, I lost it, and it was just gone. They could never find it. It was gone. And Lewis just
Ralph played it with it for 2 minutes,
and Lewis goes, he ended it 2 minutes.
The way that it went, like, could you imagine, like, these are like buildings in New York, oh, right? Dude. And the drone was like, oh, look at that, it's going, wow, and it just went
gone
forever.
And by the way, Lewis goes, yeah, I don't know, and then went and got a hot dog. One of the funniest things I've ever seen in my life.
Was he pissed?
Yeah, yeah. He was mad. Why would he's he like, Lewis, you got to help me get it. And then they realized it was between two buildings with one of those steep drop-offs for like trash and shit.
And it wasn't happening.
They never found it.
That's fucking great.
Someone walked out of their apartment and they're like, what the fuck is that drone doing here?
Remember there was a fucking...
Yeah, and can I say something about my parties, by the way? I invited you guys up and had like a party for you guys, right? Remember it was just all like the Young Bucks? Like... Colin and them didn't
You threw
come.
Us a party?
When?
The barbecue. And remember the pool?
Oh, we went over to the pool.
And you took over and you did the pool and you...
No, I wasn't there for that.
Remember that?
I remember
And
that.
You were naked running down my street.
Oh, yeah. The time I streaked.
I guess my mouth was too small to get there.
Jesus, this again. For a small mouth, you should have got big problems about it. That sucked. I'll take the band down.
That, less than 4 parsecs. That sucked.
I'm sorry. That sucked.
That party, that was a fun party. It was all you guys.
Yeah,
it's fine.
A lot of drugs.
Yeah, what about my party that you came and shit all over with the balloon?
Dude, your fucking party sucked.
Yeah, Joe, you can't just claim a section of the park as a party. Like, you're in a park.
And he goes like this, we'll have a balloon up so you can find it. The balloon was stuck to the ground.
Also,
it wasn't up in the air, it was stuck to. And then I show up with snacks, and he brought a bunch of fucking alternative open micers that had no food. Dude. So me and Dawn made a little basket.
Let me tell you
about
it.
She takes out the food, and all these guys start eating. I don't even know who the fuck these people are.
Let me tell you about Joe's.
They're eating all the food that
I welcome everybody. I welcome everyone.
Joe travels around with a pack of comics you've never met.
Oh, it's the worst.
And then you can't have a real conversation with him because a guy from Minneapolis is sitting there smiling at you.
I'm so trying to be racist. These people are just showing up.
I'm of service to younger comedians because I care
You're
about
groomer.
The art form.
You're a groomer, dude.
Joe, that party sucked. That was the same party that, who
Jason
was it?
Jason Kanner.
Dude, there was a fucking little kid that was excited about our balloon.
He was a deaf kid, too. Special needs.
I don't remember the kid was deaf.
Yeah. I swear to God.
Dude, this fucking kid was so excited about the balloon, and then like, I guess he was like running towards the balloon. And Kanner, to be funny, like it was a gag. Like this woman is like watching her kid like sort of like run towards this group of like,
I go, Mama, I want to play with the balloon.
Dude, Kanner grabs the kid as a joke, picks it up, and starts to like run away with it to be funny.
Yeah.
The woman's like, what the? Like, go, you see her.
Oh, I got another story from
goes,
that part.
I'll never have to be so mean to me.
Doggy, it was fucking the wildest thing. We were all like, dude, you can't, just like you can't, like, Calta can't grab somebody's phone.
Yeah.
You can't grab somebody's child and start running away with it.
I think one is worse than the other.
I think if they have special
needs,
you can do
whatever
you want.
Wait, Kanner grabbed the kid and ran away?
Yes.
Dude, he didn't run away. He picked it up.
To be funny,
we were like,
picked it up?
That's very funny.
He picked it up and then did a couple of like gag.
Stop calling it.
Yeah.
Well, you can't hear.
Oh, yeah,
not right. Full human.
Yeah, he's going to watch the video and read the lips.
There was another
that kid had a problem because Kanner picked him up. Guys, we can just talk like this.
There was another great moment. We were playing Frisbee, and you're not really supposed to play ball or Frisbee games in Sheep Meadow. And some guy like yelled at us. Some guy was like, hey, you got to keep the Frisbee away from us. And then Lewis showed up to the party and was like, hey, let's throw Frisbee. And we were like, we kind of get spoken to. We don't want to be assholes. And Lewis is like, I don't give a fuck. And then I threw the Frisbee to Lewis, and he double hand slapped it at the guy. Did this. Lewis just showed up and wanted to fight the guy. He wasn't even there.
Yeah,
the
he felt
he
it. He just
us.
Felt it in his bones.
Yeah.
Like, this guy's going to be a problem in a steam room one day.
Yeah.
But you know what's crazy?
I hope I run across you at an Equinox.
I have photos from those parties, and it was a different time. I think Trump and everything. It was comics from every group there. I have photos of like you and like nameless like Brooklyn
like hipstery.
Everyone just hung
out. Nobody. Nah, we didn't hang out. Back in the day, comedy was the common thing. And if you did that, that's all that mattered.
Well,
you could be a fucking lawyer. You could be a homeless person. You could be right wing, left wing. It was comedy. And we were like, dude, that's the most important thing. There's nothing else that mattered except for that. And then everything else started mattering more than just comedy.
Grifting. Everyone learned that you
could grift. Grifting?
Eric Grifter. I don't know if you met him.
Yeah, but they had alt rooms back then. I mean, I remember when I was coming up in New York, they had the alt rooms over there that they wanted Rafiki. Nothing to fucking do with us.
But that was different. That was clubs.
They would let you know.
It was still about comedy. It was club comic versus all comic. It wasn't about politics.
I remember that club comic versus all comic.
I think
it was
club comic
versus. Yeah, now it's political. Back then it was just like there was different scenes, right? But now it's like super political. Like there are people that hate me. People like that I've known for, like, I've known Ted Alexandro for a really
long
time.
He hates you?
I think he hates me.
Yeah, but this might be in your head, too.
No,
yeah.
Maybe not. He unfollowed me on stuff. And
he's a sweet guy.
Yeah, no, but he unfollowed me on stuff.
Yeah,
like,
that's weird. When someone unfollows you, you're like, what?
What's your I had another comic who I won't say the name. It's a female comic came with me who I've known for fucking 2 decades or a decade and a half at least.
Rachel Feinstein.
And she goes, in her grandma's voice, she's like, I'm a, you're a Nazi.
That's pretty great.
No, this chick, she goes, I guess she saw me, like, doing this. At a White Lives Matter rally, and
when I was storming the Capitol.
So here I am, January 6th. No, I was doing this, and now I don't even remember the context. I don't know if I was trying to be funny and do like a white power thing, like on it was on the Whitney roast. This happened 2 nights ago. She's like, "Hey, can I talk to you for a minute?" She's like, "I saw you like doing this like on your Instagram." She's like, "Are you like a white supremacist? Are you like into like that?" And I was like, yeah. Do you not know me?
It gets me fucking fired up.
Yeah. No, and I was like, no. She was like, I don't like, why were you like doing that? I was like, I could have easily been making that joke. I was like, but I also could have been saying A-okay and somebody caught a picture of me doing that. But like, it literally kind of bummed me out. I was like, I've known you a really, really long time.
And you think that I'm that.
And you, like, but it was more commentary on where their mind is at. And, like, it's almost like you're so batshit and so, like, into this political thing that you've known me for this long.
Yeah,
like,
they get riled up because they reach it online.
I almost want to fucking tell you the fucking.
You're going
hey,
to.
Hey, do it.
You can't off air.
You can off air.
We can cut it out.
I'm going to text it to you guys right now.
Oh, sick. Yeah. You know what my favorite one is?
Jessica Kirsten?
When Shane got in trouble, there was a bunch of comics who didn't know him who were like really out loud talking shit about him. And then now that he's ascended to the top, it's funny to watch those same people ball wash him.
Yeah.
There's like 2 people I know that were actively like, Shane Gillis is a problem. And then now he's the top and they're like, he's the best thing going. And
really?
Like, and I said to one of them, I go, you remember when we were in Toronto and you were shitting on him in a van?
Oh, you called him out?
Yeah. And they go, oh, well, I didn't know him. And you're like, yeah, sure.
Okay. You know what, Joe, you walk between both worlds, though.
Joe's pretty good at walking between both worlds.
You're a day walker. You can.
I just texted you.
It's going to surprise you. I'm so excited.
I'm on airplane mode because I'm a professional.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't get it.
You didn't get it. I don't have your number saved.
What?
Oh.
Did you
That's
not send
surprising.
It to me?
Surprising.
Why didn't you send it to me?
But yeah, I can hang out with anybody.
That doesn't surprise me at all.
That surprised me.
Really?
In a massive way.
Really?
Hmm.
That doesn't surprise me.
That is. I just texted her. I go, what the fuck?
I mean.
I go, do you know Lewis is.
What? She's at Skankfest every year.
That's crazy.
This is what I'm saying. Why I think it's even like almost like maybe like an issue like with her mental state. Where I'm like, you really know me.
Yeah.
Like you like you've been around for a long time.
I mean, that's
time.
Someone that's not a person where I thought you were gonna tell me like a fringe person that I would.
No, this is
like,
a person.
Can I be honest with you? I don't know who that person is.
That's funny.
But don't
she,
you?
She came up. She came
can
up.
You show
with
me a picture. Yeah. I don't know who the fuck.
She came up with us. She's been
really?
Around.
Yeah. And the real only reason I'm not because honestly I really like
and you
her.
Know her
and yeah. I think honestly yeah. She's a, I think she's in a like a. Like a fucked up mental.
Yeah, I think there's problem. Happened to me with someone recently where I called DeRosa and I was like, dude, I hung out with this guy tonight at the club. He fucking sucks. What a tough hang. I was just calling DeRosa to shit on him.
Yeah.
And DeRosa goes, dude, he's like, he's really going through something right now.
Really?
And then I replayed everything, like kind of what you did with the, and I was like, oh, okay. Yeah, that makes all sense.
But you would know her. She's the host of the Samantha Bee Project. but don't you think you should be able to hang out with everybody? I try to lead by example.
I do, but can I say something? Like when I went to your party that day, they were
like 10 years ago?
Whatever the fuck that was.
Yeah.
I showed up, like my wife, my kid, snacks, and They were.
He named his kid Snacks.
That's what he calls Max.
Snacks.
Snacks.
Snacksimus.
Snacksimus. Snacksimus.
Snacksimus. Let's go.
Snacksimus. Tasty Kelby. Clean your room. That's his full name.
Are you done?
Snacksimus.
Yeah, I got. I mean, I didn't lose. Fucking rolling.
I've been done since it started.
Fuck you. I'm sorry about the mouth comment.
Snacks. We're taking it out. Snacks Kelly's funny.
Yeah, but when I was there, they kind of made me feel uncomfortable. They kind of weren't talking to me. I was trying to strike.
They're a little.
You are intimidated.
They're open micers, and you're intimidated.
You're very.
This happens.
But
I think
I'm very
sometimes.
Friendly to these people.
Once you get people to know that you're friendly.
Yeah, but I'm always nice. Hey, what's up? What's going on? I'm not an asshole.
I do think this happens in comedy sometimes because we're all a little socially fucked up, and sometimes people will be like, those guys are clicky, or they're this, or they're that, but I'm like, they're probably just shy and nervous and
awkward,
weird.
Whatever it is. But also, Bubby, when you showed up at that party, your body blocked the sun, so I think everyone was kind of bummed out.
I wasn't fat. I wasn't everyone was fat. Bummed out. I was not fat at that point.
Yeah, you were.
That was a skinny. Yeah. Bubby, at his party?
Yeah.
Dog. That was a skinny.
You were fat. Bobby.
No, I wasn't.
Bubby.
Were you there?
Bubby, you weren't skinny.
I was skinny at the party.
Bobby, you're skinny now.
I don't remember.
Now.
I mean, it was when literally 10 years
Bobby,
ago.
You're skinny now.
Listen to me. Listen to me.
Skinny.
Listen to me.
You're not skinny when currently, and you're the skinniest I've ever seen you.
I didn't say I was skinny now.
I said you're skinny.
I don't care. You have a big head, you have a small mouth, and you have a shit disposition. How's that?
When did you learn disposition?
I learned it a week ago. I heard it.
When
on,
did you?
I heard it on Instagram.
What? You still mad about the mouth thing?
No, it's a bit. You sound like a fucking YouTube commenter. It's a joke, a bit.
First off, you know that I have multiple burner YouTube accounts.
All right, second off, don't ever say first off if you don't have a second off.
Third off, suck my nuts.
I am starving.
All right, listen.
I'm starving to nauseam.
I hate you.
Oh, my abs hurt so much. I got my laugh because I have an ab roller that I got at home. So it's
more like a flab roller.
You're right.
DanSoder.com. I'll be all over the place, including Raleigh, North Carolina, and good nights. Also, DanSoder.com for live dates. I said that already. I love you guys.
Make sure you check out Lewis's special, Gas Digital. It's out today. He is fucking hilarious. He murders on his special. All the specials from Gas Digital are fucking bangers.
Five out of six.
Except for one. Except for one.
Is there one that was a problem? Oh, man. I can't wait to go off air.
I have an hour special. My third in 3 years. The perfect amount,
Not
Lewis.
Too much.
By the way, even with this, there's still going to be comments going, yeah, list is a bit. That's why they edited it. And it wasn't
me. Did we all get shit?
It wasn't me.
Was we all get
was
shit.
It was fat fucking fuckhead. But yeah, it's on YouTube.
Joe, why'd you make us edit the show?
You're not RobertKellyLive.com anymore?
RobertKellyLive.com.
I have a sticker. My first notebook.
Yeah, RobertKellyLive.com.
Still got the app.
All my... Thank you. That was a good... I like the way... Yes, you're such a goddamn professional. RobertKellyLive.com for all my dates. I'm touring this summer. I'm on the bonfire every day. Crackle, crackle.
Crackle, dude. Crackle for life.
And check out... Rules. Check out, you know what, dude, podcast. Subscribe, like, comment, spread the word. And of course, what?
We're doing podcasts?
Lewisofskanks.com.
Yes, Lewisofskanks.com.
Check out my live dates. Me, Dave Smith, co-headlining in London, Amsterdam, and Glasgow.
Woo!
That's going to be awesome. You are fantastic.
Chicago's coming up. Brand new tour starting in January.
You have to go see Lewis on tour.
He is the best.
But how excited for Skankfest?
I'm very excited for Skankfest. Shout out to your
any
sponsoring.
Surprise things you can tell us?
There would be surprises. Are you really canceling?
You can't give us a little taste of something?
I am leaving Sunday morning.
What?
I have road shit on Monday. That
corporate
I
got.
I gotta leave Saturday.
Yeah, I told Christine from the jump.
I gotta leave Saturday.
You're kidding?
Yeah.
The fuck are you guys doing?
We gotta do bonfire on Saturday.
I gotta do bonfire. I gotta do bonfire. Oh, at the place?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
You're doing bonfire.
I'm leaving Sunday.
I will miss my child's birth for Skankfest. I've been in arguments with comics. You can't miss this.
No. Skankfest is probably.
Oh my god!
The funnest. I mean,
honestly,
last year Vegas was the funnest festival I've ever been to.
So goddamn fun, and if you put me back at the fucking Golden Palace or whatever it is.
Golden Nug?
I'm going to get those mozzarella sticks that knocked my dick in.
Oh, you want to be back at the Golden Nug?
No.
Can we bleep the Nug just in case?
You guys,
Golden Nugger?
Check out Joe List, Dan Soder, Louis J. Gomez. I'm Robert Kelly. We made it through another episode. Yeah. I mean,
we're gonna get to 12.
We're gonna get to 12.
Thank God I got involved.
Season 1.
We'll see you guys next week on the Regz. You know what?
Not next week. Next month.
Next year.
You're
maybe.
Asshole.
I'm never doing this again.
Guys, double the downloads. I'll convince Dan and Joe to do it twice a month.
I will never do this again.
Why are you gonna convince me?
Because you have nothing else going on. You love this.
I'm on the bonfire.
You love this.
I have the bonfire.
Yeah. You want me on that wall.
You need me on that wall.
We'd probably wrap it up, right?
Yep, bye.